both sides pretty evenly matched and looking good for what should be a big clash.
That's a terrific tackle there. Into the pocket, Stengel. Great finish.
Five big five. Tobin Cox. Snack it through, he has.
High ball. Great grabs. Get the margin back to 10 points. And he's done just that. Crows highest score of the year and top of the ladder as well for the first time in 3 years. Gets the Magpies underway and he's kicked a goal. It's a 30-point lead for the Magpies.
Long kick. Have a look at that.
Coverage for the big fella comes out and grabs another. A 30-point victory for the Magpies over the Crows.
To the Adelaide Oval for the qualifying final between Port Adelaide and the Crows. Just earlier, Norwood got over Sturt in what was a pretty good elimination final, so they live to fight another day, the Redlegs. This is a double chance final for these two teams, and with the Adelaide Footy Club, of course, not in at AFL level, and obviously same with Port Adelaide. So their first final at SANFL level between these two clubs, and the sides, lots of changes coming in, and we'll check those in just a moment, obviously because of qualification for SANFL finals and so forth. Just looking at the recent form, Rhett Biggins joins me, and Biggles, well, looking at Adelaide, they have only won one of their past six games, and that was against the bottom side.
Now that win against Westies by 65 points, West Adelaide were actually with them up to half time, and who would have thought Adelaide were top of the table after round 12 with just one loss, but have really come back to the pack with a few positional changes, and if we look at the Adelaide lineup now, certainly there's been a lot of players come in and out of this side due to AFL duties. There was some questions over Andy Otten tonight as well, a little bit of gastro floating around. He is lining up after having a week off. He was nice and fresh. He travelled to Ballarat as an emergency, but will take his place tonight and could be a key matchup with Billy Frampton this afternoon. Great to see Darcy Fogarty in there as well.
Yeah, they have 12 AFL listed players. Of course, Andy Otten has retired, but he is a part of that group there. For Port Adelaide, well, their form has been terrific recently. They've won 9 of their past 10 games, and the only loss was to the top side.
They destroyed the Dogs last Saturday by 90 points in round 17. They were a little inaccurate against Sturt, still getting over the line, and down at Alberton as well when they took on the Panthers.
Yep.
Certainly got some good form. They are a powerful unit at the moment.
Absolutely, no doubt about that. You look at that lineup there, 17 AFL listed players.
They actually got the same amount of wins as Glenelg. It was just a couple of draws which got Glenelg to the top of the table. Trent McKenzie returning from AFL duties back versus after playing its Fremantle, as well as William Drew as well, who was pretty good, I thought, in his AFL match. And certainly Billy Frampton, this man here, is in terrific form. Fourth most marks in the league. Booted 7 goals versus the Dogs in his last outing and was pretty much unstoppable. And he's finished 5th on the Ken Farmer medal. And his accuracy has been brilliant. 32 goals, just 11 behinds.
Fantastic. 19-10 in his past 5 weeks. Of course, he did kick a bag against the Crows, and that was when they were up at Port Pirie. He was able to kick 6 goals. Andy Otten, number 22. There he is there. Look, he's had a wonderful career of persistence. Had some injuries over the journey, and I did have a chat to him yesterday, Biggles, and he said he's very, very keen to take this opportunity and try and win some finals footy.
16th in the SANFL for rebound 50s. He was chaired off the ground in Ballarat and eyeing off a coaching career as well. Played his 100th last year in the AFL and 2 ACL reconstructions. Let's get down to Andrew Hayes on the boundary.
Good on you, Biggles. Really looking forward to this one. No late changes for both sides. There's a little bit of dew out there, which will make it slippery, especially early on. But in terms of the weather, right now 17 degrees. We could see some showers across Adelaide Oval in the second half, though. So vital both sides get off to a fast start and apply some early scoreboard pressure.
Good on you, Hazy. And let's have a look at our RAA rookies. $500 goes to the junior club of this man, James Matthews. And his club is McLaren.
Yeah, McLaren Football Club down the Great Southern League. And who can forget that remarkable goal that he kicked versus South Adelaide in that draw a few months ago when he shoved off Emmanuel Ira, who was trying to tackle him. And he'll start on the interchange bench tonight, but look for him to have that flexibility in his game. And a lot of talent floating around there in the supplementary list, or the top-ups, if you like, for the Adelaide Crows.
Well, John Casey joins us now, and he'll get us kicked off.
Qualifying final. Really looking forward to this clash, the showdown between Port Adelaide and the Adelaide Crows. Port Adelaide with 10 players who have played AFL this year. 42 games, including that man, Peter Laddams, and the Adelaide Crows with eight players who have played in the AFL this year for a total of 37 games. As we get set to go, the winner books an appointment with Glenelg, the loser to face Norwood next week. The qualifying final underway. Ruck work, Laddams wins the tap, sharked by Chase Jones. He's dispossessed, goes back for seconds, and now wrestled to the ground. And the umpire's going to come in. We'll have a secondary ball up. No, in fact, a free kick going the way of Chase Jones against Cam Sutcliffe. Just got a little too overzealous with the tackle. In fact, no, it's holding the ball. Holding the ball is the call. And Sutcliffe gets Port going forward, or at least sideways, and in the direction of the southern end. They won the toss and elected to kick to the southern end. We saw Norwood do that as well. And I think that's more about the protection the Riverbank stand end offers, because the flags here are limp at the moment and not a lot of breeze to speak of.
So lining up deep is Todd Marshall standing in the goal square. He's a dangerous player with a lot of space out in front of him. And Chase Jones starting in the centre bounce. That's a really good positive move for Adelaide.
Willem Drew with it with the left boot. Going four, they want Frampton. Odden right there with him. Knocks the ball to ground. Matty Wright comes through solidly. He's wrapped up by multiple tackles, going nowhere, but no prior opportunity. Umpire Kim Zim will ball it up. A minute played here. Port Adelaide working to the right of screen with the early ascendancy. Hayes tried to do the ruck work, couldn't get it to the advantage of a teammate. Again, we've got a gaggle of players around it, and we'll have another ball up.
That's the matchup we wanted with Andy Otten on Billy Frampton. They're both like for like. Andy likes to sit back in the hole and protect play, but he's going to have to man up pretty tightly as well. And his intercept marking, Andy Otten, over his career has been outstanding. He's got a really clever football brain of following the flight of the ball.
Ruckwork being done by Sam Hayes. Great to see him back after that knee reconstruction that he had, and tackle from Drew.
Getting in and under, and Miles Beholking, well, he's had an outstanding year as well at SANFL level, averaging it really classy possessions and used it pretty well.
Merritt from defence, picked up by Leanett. He's played premiership with Sturt in the past. He goes long with a goal. He draws first blood, a magnificent kick by Jared Leanett.
So an errant kick out of the defensive 50 here by Adelaide, and have a look at the launch from Jared Leanett. He has hit this absolutely flush. Made his AFL debut versus the GWS Giants, and that one there, that is a great start.
Fourth goal of the season for Jared Leanett there on the National Pharmacy's optical replay. Played 10 games of SANFL this year, Leanett, as well as seven of the AFL. Here's Stengel taking the mark between the wing and half forward. Looks up, and the pass is a good one as he finds Jordan Boyle, the left footer from Salisbury North, brings it back centrally. Frederick couldn't control the mark. Chance now for Adelaide, and the quick kick, that they got the smart reply. Looks good off the boot. Ned McHenry has kicked the goal for Adelaide there first.
Chase Jones goes one step bang on that left of his, and that is deadly accurate. Not missing a beat after returning from AFL duties after he took on the Bulldogs.
Couple of great goals to start with from Leanett, and also for Jones. Himmelberg doing the ruck work with a clearance up in the direction of Fogarty. So he can play some good AFL football at the tail end of the season. Quick kick from Garner, clearing out of defence. Punch knocked forward. Sam Davidson into advantage, goes high. He's going to give away a free kick here, and going to be received here. Chance for Lockie Ryan.
Did a good job of going low, Davidson there, didn't he? So to just head over the footy.
Former West Adelaide player Ryan goes up. Getting back onto it is Hewitt. He's wrapped up in a tackle. Again, Hewitt again has to lay that tackle, and trying to get into former Eagle there, Jackson Press.
So stoppages are going to be a different basket for Adelaide tonight, because they've had Sam Jacobs throughout the year, they've had O'Brien throughout the year as well, and Hunter also. So they're just filling gaps in there with Himmelberg at the moment.
Clearance belongs to Port Adelaide. Marshall just shuffled underneath the ball by Pierce Seymour. Hand pass comes out. Although they're going forward once more, the Magpies. Inside their attacking 50, cleaning up Pierce Seymour with a run there of Matt Merritt. Been impressed with his season. One of their best defenders. But Leanett's got it now for Port Adelaide. He's got time to measure the kick as well. Really didn't work it to the advantage of Frampton there. Didn't do him many favours at all. And an easy mark able to be taken by Otten, who gets it out now to Gallucci. Off with a bounce, short kick. And it was a target of Himmelberg, who goes back to Gallucci. Just bobbled the hand pass, invited trouble. Joe Attlee said, I've got you now. And he's dragged down in tandem with Todd Marshall. And you make ball handling errors, and these teams are going to make you pay.
Gallucci had one look at it. I do like the run out of the defence. The umpire's paid at 25 here. Gallucci got his hand in there, and Cody Marshall whacked it out. Umpire was right on the spot.
Just looking at the tackle count at the moment, Port Adelaide has started hot. 10 tackles to 2. Real intent from the Maggies. Kick up. Sam Hayes going back, but Andy Otten takes his second good mark there in defence. Looking for perhaps a career as a development coach to start his progress, or may even consider playing some football in the SANFL if he isn't at an AFL club working next year. As over the back, Fogarty, big stretch over Leanert. Himmelberg out to Fogarty. The umpire's whistle, play on. No, he's going to bring it back. Just as McHenry was off and ready to go, it's going to come back to Port Adelaide. And big pistol, Pete Laddams with his kick. Turned over, Wilson's got it.
His handball disrupted, but found a teammate there in Chase Jones. His kick off the money. And Trent McKenzie takes the mark. Had 21 disposals and 4 marks against Frio last week. His only game at AFL level. Oh, he did well there. Sells some candy and now drives long. Look at the depth of this as he wants Marshall, but getting across and taking a good mark. Pierce Seymour getting one for his corner as well. More dangerous kick now across the ground. He opened the door there for Sam Mays, who knocked it down, got it to Todd Marshall, who measures the shot at goal, but it's wayward. He pushes it across the face, and a little bit going on here between Matty Wright and Todd Marshall.
Great positioning from Pierce Seymour, that mark of his. A really strong mark. The kick wasn't his greatest, but his positioning around the ground, Pierce Seymour, and his intercept marking has really grown his game in just 7 matches. It's been real improvement.
Frederick with the punch, comes out to Gallucci. Little low kick. Just didn't have enough on it to help out McAdam. Drew into him and pick up the free kick. 16 goals for the year for McAdam. Kick just to Wilson. Handball shoots it out to Scholl, and he lowers the eyes. Mark taken here by Jackson Press. So he's too far out probably, or he's let fly, and he's just not going to get the distance there. And Trent McKenzie makes sure that it goes through against Stengel.
Great defensive work for McKenzie, making sure he didn't leave it to a one-on-one with the dangerous Stengel. If he had got it to ground, putting a fist right through it, coaches love that. Kill the play, get it over the line. He started well so far, Trent McKenzie. Good positive body language, 3 disposals already.
Like this out of fullback as well, as he hammers it to almost the centre circle. We're all 36, we're compressed into one half of the ground. So good pressure release. And there's Leanert going back with a flight of the ball and taking a good mark as well. This is Sutcliffe. Handball over the top now. It's got the run of Hewitt. Forced a kick with the left. And a little indiscriminate. Favours Andy Otten. Needs a kind bounce though. Paddles it to his own advantage. Marshall put some pressure on. Did enough to work him into error. Now Marshall around the body. Well, he kicked without looking there and gave it up very quickly. And here's Will Hamill, the 18-year-old, the youngest player out there. And they're out here as Matthew Wright gets it up to Stengel. He's got space to move into here. Works inside the attacking 50, wants the short lead. And the mark's being taken here. And a good job of it as well by McAdam.
Great composure there from Stengel. We knew that he was driving towards the left point post. And he's a right footer, of course, so didn't have time to prop. But McAdam went back and had a movement back at the leader. And nice finish, putting it right out in front. Hard to defend against that one.
Injury interrupted season for McAdam, but 2 goals last week in the loss at South Adelaide. Looking for his 17th goal of the season. Looks good off the boot, and he gets the second, and Adelaide take the lead for the first time in the game.
Nice little weighted kick, Stengel out in front. McAdam, watch this beautiful goal-kicking style of his. Just gets a left-right, knows this stage pretty well after being out here for Sturt, and hoping he can string some consecutive games together after those nasty hammies.
Yeah, 12th game of the year for the 24-year-old. 17 goals now to put the Crows in front by 6 points. Trying to work his way through the centre of the ground was Stengel, and he's been pinged. So Leanert has to give it back to Drew. And the umpire making sure that Stengel just comes back on the mark. So Drew goes up forward. Otten again in best position. Coming across there was Marshall. Davidson's got to work his way through. He does. 52 out. He's kicked into the pocket. He's going to roll out, and Crows will get the restart. Last possession out of bounds.
Marshall's presenting up well. That was a nice contested area where he brought it to the ground, flew for the ball and followed up on the ground as well. So the key pronged attack with Frampton and Marshall so far proving a danger for Port Adelaide.
Ryan restarts his Stengel. Hand pass. Still works at two. Corey Davey gets involved. Now it's Elliot Himmelberg. And they've worked this well here through Hamill. Paholke about to be run down. Matt Merritt just gets his kick away, but it was disrupted under the pressure. McKenzie's there playing the quarterback role once more and brings it out nicely as he finds Sam Mays. His kick, well, just half volley. Well done by Marshall. And now he's very good beneath his knees. Now Frampton wrapped up in a strong tackle from Ned McHenry. And the Crows force the error and are out. And again, they're rushing off out off half back. And the mark's been taken here by Jackson Press, who's been lively so far. He's going deep. Wants McAdam, who works to the front. Did a good job of there. May have won a free kick against Corcoran. And they'll bring it back here for McAdam. Wants to go short. Lead comes now. And that was an easy lead. Got some separation there. Darcy Fogarty, and he's taken the mark easily. Going to shoot from 35 metres out. Not much of an angle to speak of.
So we're already getting a glimpse of Adelaide's ball movement. They're number one in the competition for marks on a lead. Number two for marks in general. They love the player coming at them with a short kick. So Port Adelaide won't be able to sag off. They've got to go stride for stride.
First round draft pick, kick goals in both games against Port Adelaide in the minor round, and he continues that good form. Adelaide have kicked three in a row and have opened up a 12-point advantage.
Here's the lead up again, looking as easy as you like. You were thinking, where's the Port Adelaide defence? But the Darcy Fogarty kicking style, compact, straight, and very accurate. He's 12th in the sample for marks on the lead, and I've got to shot him down that way this afternoon.
Big powerful legs on the boy from Loosendale, and the Crows are now out by 12 points as Trengove. We've just seen back in the side, missed some footy in the middle part of the year, was just racking up the stats early on, averaging 32 a game as Otten tries to break away. Sutcliffe has his kick smothered just as he goes forward. Hamill gets back onto it under enormous pressure there from Farrell. And the umpire will take control here, 40 out from the Crows goals. Andrew Hayes is on the boundary.
Darcy Fogarty certainly is a talent. Trent McKenzie started on him, which was an interesting matchup. Went off him, and then Joel Garner got a gig, quickly kicked the goal. So Trent McKenzie gets back on him just to try and see if he can quell the superstar because he's so strong on the lead.
Well, they're working well at the moment, Adelaide, and they're bustling it forward once more. Fogarty going to do the shepherding here, trying to get Stengel a run at the ball. Port Adelaide with some problems. Good tackle from Fogarty. Now it was a little high according to the umpire, mitigating circumstances for him. With a free kick going Port Adelaide's way to be taken by Joel Garner, and he's off quickly, looking out wide, and he finds Trengove.
He actually put some separation on McKenzie then, the Fog, and they were grinding through the gears. The big B-double bus was charging through, wasn't it? It just couldn't get down low enough, though.
Up to the wing. No one can complete the mark. Hutchison with it. Now Paddy Wilson signed another contract with Adelaide. His kick, though, is going to be cut out. Lynn, oh, he was crunched by Fogarty. He can put himself about Darcy Fogarty. He's a big, strong player. He's given away the 25-metre penalty. And as you can see, Lena, well, that's going to hurt.
Crunched him. Now, there's some feeling out there. Don't worry about that. The first ever SANFL finals match. And when the last time these two sides met, Billy Frampton absolutely destroyed Wilson, knocked him out cold. So there'll be memories.
Ball with Trengove now. Otten just corralling him. Long, big thump back from Frampton to McKenzie. We know he's got a powerful kick and goes long and dangerously close to the line. Still in, so kick from Woodcock around the corner. Ryan straight through his hands. Sam Mays working overtime as well. And Wilson just picking it up and tries to take it with him. He's got Sutcliffe on his back. And the umpire's going to ball it up. Andrew Hayes.
We're just seeing some interesting vision on the Port Adelaide bench. Bit of mix of AFL and SANFL. Of course, the rules in the AFL, runners don't have much use out there. So he put up the signs to say there's less than 10 minutes. I think the rule's a little bit different in the SANFL, but still, we're giving it a go, the AFL rules in the SANFL.
Well, most interesting. Here's Frampton. Long hand pass for Lennett. Appears to have recovered. Wanted to get onto his right boot. Uses Drew. Sold Davidson into trouble. Just dropped the ball. Looked like incorrect disposal from here. Umpire didn't see it that way. To the top of the square. Good grab. Corey Davey. Had to juggle it. could release some pressure now. That was a good mark under pressure. And he slows it down. Almost 17 minutes played here in the opening quarter of the qualifying final. Winner to face Glenelg. Loser to go up against Norwood, who defeated Sturt earlier by 14 points in the closest elimination final in 7 years. And here's McAdam. Oh, he's off and running. Too much toe for Willem Drew. Invited the contact there as well. Got the handball away. Matt Appleton onto the ground for Port Adelaide, trying to slow them down. Bounce important here. It goes over the back. And a chance now for Jackson Press, or didn't fall kindly for him. And relieving some pressure, Trent McKenzie's got it out wide. And now Sutcliffe, who's got a paddock in front of him, uses the short pass to Laddams. Kept running. And now Laddams, he drives deep. Looking over the back, good mark. Tobin Cox with it now. And he's going quickly to the top of the square. They've got multiple targets here. And it's Mays floating across the front who takes the grab. Adelaide appealing for a free kick. Pierce Seymour says he was inconvenienced by his immediate opponent. As you can see, Boyd Woodcock just bodying Pierce there. And the drop of the ball is with Sam Mays. He's kicked 3 goals, 12 this season in the SANFL. Sam Mays, best player for the Magpies last week in the 90-point win over Central District with a game-high 34 disposals, 8 clearances and a goal. And this to get Port Adelaide second. He makes no mistake and he shaves the lead down to just 6 points.
So this was the kick coming from Tobin Cox. You'll see Boyd Woodcock just have a quick look over his shoulder. I think he disguised it well enough. Regardless, Port Adelaide get one back.
Well, Adelaide product, who spent his time up at Brisbane, now back here with the power, playing for the Maggies tonight as Pahulki. He's going to get a free kick out of this. Boy from Sorrento on the Mornington Peninsula in Victoria. Puts a kick up and mark is taken there by Tommy Corcoran. Drops it in short. Atlee. And now he's got Sam Hayes. He's kicked to Frampton. Looks like he's in a good spot. So here goes Big Billy from 55. Goes low and hard. And the mark is taken. No free kick. Kane Farrell in a great spot there. But Hamill ends out with a free.
Oh, you can hear the Port Adelaide faithful. That was some sharp ball movement. Getting a glimpse of it here. Oh, there's not a lot in that. Umpire just destroyed one of the best passages we've seen so far. Kenny Hinkley in attendance tonight. His eyes would have lit up with that ball movement. Unlucky, though.
That's both Kenny Hinkley and his opposite number, Dom Pye from Adelaide, are here watching, as you might expect. So much of their young talent on show here. And a chance now for Adelaide to get the ball forward. Now a chance. It's for Hutchison. Got it from Boyle. His kick to centre-half forward. Well, good tackle, Martin Frederick, as he dragged Chase Jones down. And he hit the deck solidly, Chase Jones. I know he's had injury problems this year. That was dumped into the turf here. It's McKenzie gets it once more. He's been busy. Disposal number 7 for McKenzie. No one has more in the game. And now Port Adelaide slow it down. We're into time on in this opening quarter, and Kane Farrell looks up to half forward. Tobin Cox at the back. He launches himself skyward. Couldn't complete the mark, close to the boundary line, and in fact now Lockie Ryan is dragged over.
He's taken his game to another level, Tobin Cox. 25 goals, 12 this year after his 5-goal haul against the Doggies. As I mentioned, he was shadowed there by Big Billy Frampton, booting 7, but that was a terrific performance, the boy from Pathaway.
Laddams. Sutcliffe slaps it back into the path of Trengos. He goes off the deck, and mark has been taken by the man you were just talking about, Tobin Cox. As he Billy, he's got some strong hands for a man who stands only 179 centimetres and goes around, plays on, long kick, and way off target.
Sometimes they play it, some players call for it in positions that they probably shouldn't be given to. I'd rather Tobin Cox go back and use that footy. He's a pretty good user of the ball. Spent some time at Glenelg, Tobin Cox. He then had that lacerated kidney this year, which set him back a long time.
So Adelaide methodically up to Wilson via Merritt, who got it from Scholl. Now called to play on. Almost 22 minutes played in this opening quarter. Ned McHenry at close quarters takes the mark. Still inside their defensive 50. Not a lot on offer for McHenry, as you can see. No targets to kick to. He's going to go short, and he's coughed it up here. Willem Drew takes the mark. Now with multiple options, Frampton comes hard at it. Couldn't complete the mark. Dispossessed there was Joe Attlee. Now involved again, Lockie Scholl. And they're under enormous pressure here at the moment, Adelaide, but they're out of their defensive 50 through Seymour. Contact there, and it was a high contact as well. Free kick without the ball. Matt Wilson, they make a target of him, don't they? Strong tackle there from Willem Drew. And Wilson at left half back, indicating he's coming out toward the grandstand, right in front of the interchange gates. Darcy Fogarty elevates, can't complete the mark, and given some treatment by Trent McKenzie as well.
Well, that's a great pickup, John Casey, and they are targeting Patrick Wilson. And I suspect he'd probably be one of the players that coaches would put on the board and highlight, because he can have a massive influence on games, particularly around clearances. We saw last time these two sides met at Port Pirie, he was certainly targeted. Today again, Sutcliffe all over him.
Picked up by Attlee just front and centre beautifully with his kick, though it hasn't gone to his target. It's going to roll out over the line, so Matt Merritt will have the chance to bring it in. Nice possession, out of bounds rule. Well, Paddy Wilson has had a wonderful year. 27 touches he averages a game. Expecting to get plenty of McGarry medal votes in a couple of weeks' time, which you'll be able to see across the screens of seven as Leanit already kicked the goal, pumps the ball back in to attack, but just cut off there, and the mark taken by Scholl. Goes for a little low one to Jones, and he distributes it out further to Wright.
So Matty Wright, defensive side of centre wing, out of sight of the Adelaide Oval, approaching the 24-minute mark of an entertaining opening quarter. His kicks off the money, though, and getting down low and able to complete the mark, though, Trent McKenzie. In fact, it was Tom Corcoran. And there you see Frampton, Joel Garner, Sam Mays. Just getting a rest on the bench at the moment. 3-1-19, Adelaide leads Port 2-1-13. A boundary throw-in, Himmelberg wrestling with Laddams, who wins the tap, but it's sharked by Hutchison, who's dragged to the ground. Now Sutcliffe with it, wearing the number 50 jumper at the AFL level. Forward, juggling mark, not paid to Lockie Ryan. Again, Matt Merritt is there. His kick's off the money, it's wide and out of bounds on the full. So Port Adelaide will restart. For a backman, he averages 15 disposals a game, Matt Merritt, and he's been impressive this season.
Yeah, 8 marks last week. He's settled in well at this level. Possession-wise at the moment, Jack Tringo for Port Adelaide, 9 disposals.
Big bump, Merritt. That was on Attlee. Laddams, Tringo, if you just talked about him, picked up another one. Here's Frederick, looks across and decides to go back the other way, and kick needs to be a good one. Matty Wright going back against Woodcock. Two former North Adelaide players contesting in the air together.
Tringo now up to 10 disposals, and he may challenge Partington for that McGarry medal that you were talking about. Soto had a ripping year. Had a little infection in his foot, which cost him a few weeks, which may be the difference in the end.
5 games he ended up missing, so just playing the 13. But geez, he's averaging 32 possessions a game at this level. He has had a wonderful season. As the ball just farmed out there, high kick from Matty Wright. Going down towards the wing, Hewitt going back against Pahulki. Good battle between those two. Crowd looking for free kick, it's not going to come. McHenry works his way out, lead it gets to him. Not quick enough though, and the kick playing in front, McKenzie.
Great vision from McKenzie, watched the flight of the ball, had an awareness of his opponent as well, and we've got the likes of McAdam and Stengel to swap over to. McKenzie's playing a real leadership role down back tonight.
Farrell, dangerous kick on the Tringo, almost cut out by Stengel. Martin Frederick with it now, looks out wide. Good pass. Lace out. And he finds Willem Drew, a right half back for the Magpies. Took over 26 minutes played in this opening quarter. Adelaide leading by 6 points after Port Adelaide kicked the first goal of the game. Good grab, Tobin Cox. Not to like about his game, a 20-year-old. Short pass, inboard. Woodcock, teenager. Well done there as they work it to Frederick. And he goes straight down the middle of the crowd. And how about the grab being taken here by Sam Hayes? Direct football is good football. And look at this from Frederick.
Outstanding play from Frederick. Pahulki probably could have gone a bit harder just to keep the ball in the area, but Frederick broke the lines, nicely balanced. Good strong lead up from Sam Hayes. When he presents this man, he's a massive man. The glandular fever. Oh, sorry. Not Sam, it was Sam Hayes. It's a bit confused, but Sam Hayes has been pretty good this year. 8th in the league for disposals.
So Hayes Goal kicker last week. There's a goal kicker this week as well. And we are back on level terms.
That is great ball movement through the corridor. And now they've got some open space inside their forward 50 at the moment, Port Adelaide. When you've got these leading targets, the likes of Billy Frampton and the guns up there. I love the body language so far of all the forwards. They're presenting up. They're providing pressure on the ground. And Todd Marsh was doing a great job of that.
The Crows kicked three goals in a row. And then Port, goal to Sam Mays and then a goal to Sam Hayes. And suddenly we're all square here. Time on late in this first quarter. Qualifying final, Port Adelaide taking on the Crows. Elimination final, Norwood got over Sturt in a really tough battle earlier today. As Wilson back onto it. He's got Sutcliffe wearing him tightly. Gets a handball out wide, trying to work his way around. There was Boyle to Himmelberg. Gets through, drops a little kick in. And right on the siren. So it was a tight first quarter. 3-1, 19 apiece here. Qualifying final on 7 from Adelaide Oval.
Seven's iconic AFL chat show, tackling all the big issues.
The system is unfair, but our draw's unfair. I just can't believe that he's got caught up in it so much.
Setting the AFL agenda.
I'm as proud of the football club as I ever have been. Our players have got their heads screwed on right.
This week, four-time premiership star and Lions veteran Luke Hodge joins us live. Don't miss Talking Footy, Monday 7:30 on Mate.
It's been a decade of dynasties and fairy tales. On a very special game day, we look back on all the magic moments, the dramas, the news stories, and when things went wrong. We count down the best marks.
Ow!
And goals.
That's what the crowd wanted!
As well as the greatest games and the best players. Who will be number one? Game day. Moments of the decade.
Just starting to come down here at quarter time. Jack Trengove with 11 touches, leading the way as he has done for most of the year in terms of possession. So we're all square 3-1-19. Paddy Wilson leading the Crows and just single goal kickers across the board. Rhett Biglands just checking through the stats there. Have a look at the tackles. Port Adelaide 20-7.
Inside 50 count as well, 19-9. Port Adelaide averaged the second most amount of inside 50s in the competition per game. So no doubt Adelaide are going to be under pressure in their back half. But they've started well, the Adelaide Crows, because if they can get involved with contested possessions, it's another one at the moment where they're going head-to-head, because that's an important stat. 37-33, that one in favour of the Adelaide Crows. So Andrew Hayes is down the boundary line with the coach, Heath Shuni.
Thanks very much, Biggles. Heath, what did you make of the first quarter? Obviously, scoreboard, it's all locked up.
Yeah, look, I thought they probably had a bit more field position than us. We were able to defend the game really strongly. The contest numbers are pretty good. Great game of footy at the moment.
Bit of a differential in the tackles. It looked like you were really making a point out there to your team.
Yeah, look, for me, it was about, I thought we won the ball okay, so we're plus in the contest, but the tackle pressure, I thought our pressure was okay, it's just getting in the impact and finishing off. So we can keep this pressure up and keep the game being played the way we would like it. Hopefully we can put some more scoreboard pressure on.
Thanks for your time.
Good on you, mate.
Heath Uni there with Andrew Hayes. Adelaide Crows are the best second quarter team in the competition. They've won 13 out of 18 second quarters and kicked 8 goals, 1 in round 5 against Central District. That's their highest scoring quarter of the season, and they're forward here quickly. Whistle on play, free kick going the way of Adelaide. And the Magpies have got their hands full with this young man, Tyson Stengel.
Just missed Chase Jones coming out of the centre circle there. His clearance work at that centre bounce was brilliant, because they're not getting first look at it in the hit-out department at the moment. They're getting a bit of a touch up there, 14-3 in favour of Port Adelaide. And I think Peter Adams getting his hand on, but Chase Jones' clearance was just brilliant. Ball to advantage. Free kick down there as the defence start to panic.
2 goals last week for Stengel. He's kicked 30 goals, 23 this season, to be Adelaide's leading goal kicker. Stuttering approach. doesn't fill me with confidence, but he's good enough to get it done. Didn't sound sweet off the boot, but it doesn't matter how, it's how many. And Adelaide have got another.
Free kick coming in now. You can clearly see the jumper being pulled there. And Tyson Stengel's a worry when the ball hits the ground. He was brilliant against South Adelaide, fourth best with a couple of goals. A stutter approach as he lines up here. I need to describe the approach. Just mark down the goal.
Crows out by 6 points. Stengel with four goals at Alderton back in round seven when the Crows did get over Port Adelaide by 16 points. Pahulki swung around. Another tackle for Sutcliffe as Frederick fires a handball out to Trengove and he was taken down by Chase Jones. There's a tackling pressure that Heath Uni would love to see there. Great one by Jones. And the umpire gets in the way there of Drew. He couldn't get through. Laddams, how do you get rid of that? Free kick's going to go to the Crows. He made a good start to this second term straight away. Ned McHenry. Seen a bit of McHenry and also Jones so far tonight. He's an effervescent character, Ned McHenry. Puts the ball in, a little bit of a wobbler. And free kick is going to go against Stengel to Pete Laddams.
Little Adams is working hard to get back into defence. His work rate from stoppage and his clearance work so far has been pretty good. Certainly his hit-outs are giving Port first look at it, but they need to capitalise on those hit-outs.
11 free kicks for Adelaide, 8 for Port Adelaide. 19 is a lot so early in the game. 3 minutes played here, second quarter action. Laddams about to be run down, bit off more than he could chew and going to pay the penalty. Well, Fogarty's got a facial for him as well. As he helps himself off the deck and goes out wide. Run provided here by Matty Wright. His short kick looking for Himmelberg, who presents, takes the mark, and a chance to go back here and kick Adelaide's fifth goal.
The Adelaide players get over to the Fog, congratulate him on his effort. As P. Laddams bit off a lot more than he could chew, tried to balk his opponent and come in, and two Adelaide players jumped on him, brought him to ground, and they swing it back into attack, and Himmelberg with a strong lead up.
Goal kicker last week at South Adelaide. Kicked three goals and was in the best players with 11 disposals and five marks at round 13 at Port Pirie. But on the season, 19-17, so he's a 50-50 proposition, really, if you look at the overall numbers, and just pushes it to the near side and a minor score. Adelaide, 4-2-26, lead Port Adelaide, 3-1-19.
Yeah, the Queenslander, Elliot Himmelberg, seventh in the competition for marks on a lead, so you know the style he's going to play when he's resting up there, but of course spending a fair bit of time on the ruck tonight.
Drew to Sutcliffe has a look at what was going past and decides just to kick it up to Sam Hayes. His kick into the direction of Marshall. He's got some separation from Seymour, goes around with the kick. Fogarty in the best position, punches away. Sutcliffe trying to get back onto it. Got Wilson to deal with, gives it to Garner, and kick is out the full.
Skills just lacking at the moment from Port Adelaide. Seen Laddams run down. Marshall's kick really wasn't to the advantage of a teammate. And Garner out on the full. So Adelaide back up the grandstand wing, looking for Himmelberg. Stood tall. Three bites at it. Completes the mark. Wants to get on with it quickly as well. Dangerous kick into the middle. Misses the target. Mays is there. Frederick in support. Short pass. He finds Frampton. Lead comes now. And it was a good lead from Marshall, who slides down to his knees and takes the mark. He'll be able to shoot at goal from 45 out on a 45-degree angle.
Coming out for disposal number seven, Todd Marshall. And he came out of that full-chested. It's a nice kick from Billy Frampton. Couldn't see the separation, but Marshall got about 10 metres on his opponent by pure speed. When he gets up and going, he's a difficult man to stop, averaging 15 disposals and a goal per game in the SANFL this year.
12 disposals, 7 marks and 2 goals, 1 against Frio in the AFL last week. 10 goals, 14 in the SANFL this season. And from just inside the paint of 50, hangs it out to the right, never had it on target. And Port Adelaide get their first score of this term. It's taken almost 6 minutes. They move to 3-2-20, trailing Adelaide 4-2-26. And the qualifying final, spot up for grabs against Glenelg next week for the winner.
Andy Otten, kick up into the direction of Fogarty. A whistle from the umpire and we'll throw it in. Or the, heard an earlier whistle just as Fogarty went for that contest. The umpire is going to throw it in here. So 6 minutes gone. Crows out by a goal. Adams and Fogarty. So no recognised ruckman in this Crows lineup. Strawn was out with concussion. Jacobs not playing. And Hunter, of course, has been injured as well. So they're using Himmelberg in the ruck tonight. We obviously saw just Fogarty doing a little bit of the work there at the throne. He'll go up again against Laddams, who is one of the most improved players in the SANFL this year.
It's a big change for the Crows. They're ranked number two in the competition for hitouts to advantage. So when you lose the likes of O'Brien, Jacobs and Hunter, it's certainly a big change.
Laddams did his own work. It ends up with Hewitt going forward. The bounce with Sam Hayes. Able to trap it. Just hands it over to Marshall. He's in a bit of trouble. Gets put the ball. Matty Wright close to the line. And we'll throw it in.
Thought Adelaide defensive pressure case so far has been outstanding, hasn't it?
Been good. It's a boundary throw in front of the old scoreboard here at Adelaide Oval. No real breeze to speak of. Still night here in Adelaide. Earlier today, we saw Norwood defeat Sturt by 14 points in the closest elimination final in 7 years. Sutcliffe hacks it out of midair and misses the lot out of bounds on the full.
Inside their attacking 50, Port Adelaide, they're really shutting down the time and space of the Adelaide defence. They're getting at them with not only tackle pressure, but perceived pressure. It's coming through work rate as well, and Todd Marshall was actually setting the example for that area.
Matty Wright, North Adelaide to the Crows, to Carlton, and now back here in his role as captain of the SANFL team, Mays. Just flicks a little handball in. Corcoran goes forward with his kick. Fogarty. Otten. Pierce Seymour there as well. Laddams goes up uncontested. Had a runner behind him. Little give came from Attlee. Jumping in there was Gallucci though to Beholke now. So they get the clearance. Adelaide going up to centre wing. McKenzie taken high. We get the free kick.
Really aggressive, absolutely lost his head there. And when you look here on the replay, a bit of frustration creeping in from Jackson Press. McKenzie's had a great start to the game. Garner helping him back there as well. Been a good defensive unit so far, and here is Garner.
On cue, comes across the ground dangerously. Stengel lurking, ball pitches well short there of Kane Farrell, who turns around on the left boot. And up the line, he finds Willem Drew. Wants to play on. Dangerous hand pass. Sold his teammate Hewitt into trouble, but he was good enough to shred the tackle there of Lockie Ryan. Into the pocket. Flying high. Nice grab from Marshall.
Outstanding overhead mark going back with the flight. You see him come into the screen here. Eyes only for the football now. There could have been any sort of player coming steaming out at him. And his body language throughout this match so far has been outstanding. Todd Marshall coming up for disposal, number 9. And his work rate to keep the ball inside forward 50 has been brilliant. Hopefully he can convert.
10 goals, 16 this season. Doesn't fill you with confidence on a tight angle like this. You need to start making and taking their opportunities. They've had more than double the amount of inside 50s from Adelaide. It's 25-12 is the inside 50 count in favour of Port. And they trail by 5 points.
There is a lot of pressure out there for the first ever SANFL final showdown. Port scored 3 goals from turnovers in that first term. The Crows got 1 from stoppage and 2 from turnover. So a lot of pressure out there, particularly in the front half of both sides.
Fogarty going up. Laddams in best position. Couldn't hold on to it. Comes back out to Attlee. Handball pinched beautifully there. There was some terrific work by Matthews. Coughed it up, though. This comes back to Drew. Attlee. And now Mays. High kick and goes long, Frampton under it, over the top with a big fly was Woodcock. Nowhere near it, in fact, but it looks spectacular for a moment. Gallucci to Fogarty. Matty Wright now down the line. Oh, good stretch too. Shane McAdam out in front. He was busy earlier in the game.
Coming out for disposal, number 5. He's working hard.
Already a goal kicker tonight, but turnover now, and mark's taken by Garner at halfback.
Been impressive, Garner. He comes across ground on mark taken here by Kane Farrell. Matty Locken, coach of Port Adelaide, has been kind enough to give us some of his time. Just starting to get things on your terms, Matty.
Oh, yeah. Look, our ball use hasn't been great today. Sorry, guys, I was just watching that. But, look, Adelaide come at us early on, and we're just a little bit fumbly with the ball, and weren't able to, I suppose, make the most of our opportunities going inside forward 50. So hopefully we can get, the game back on our terms and, start converting in front of goal.
And, Lokes, the ball you see talking about, you think, is that a result of the pressure being a final out there at the moment?
Oh, certainly. It's a finals footy, and we knew Adelaide were going to bring the heat early. So we've got to withstand that and be a little bit calmer under pressure and, as I mentioned, hopefully convert when we go inside forward 50.
Matty, we saw during the play there you're using some of the boards that we see at AFL level. Is that a tactic that you're using, or is it just you can't get the runner out there enough, or the players are just used to that being used, the AFL players?
Oh, no, we've done it all year at SANFL level. When we've needed to get out a message or a style of play, we've certainly used the board, so that's nothing new for us.
Good on you, Matty. Thanks so much for the access.
Thanks, guys.
There he is, Matty Lockin, coach of Port Adelaide. And we talked about just the efficiency going forward, and we saw that moments ago while we were talking with that wasted entry again. Himmelberg just at half-back. He's done a good job, Himmelberg, thrust into the ruck, of course, with Strawn being a late withdrawal with concussion, which meant Corey Davey came into the side, and Himmelberg took over ruck duties. Kick out to Lockie Scholl, very famous football family. Drops a kick in to Will Hamill. Some of the new faces on the Crows AFL list. Matty Wright, an old face, goes with a long kick inside 50. Best position. Trent McKenzie reads it well.
That's a wasted opportunity there for Adelaide. They didn't have any movement inside their forward 50 as that slow play was coming in. They were all waiting for it to get within range. I still think if you're moving up there, it'll take someone like a McKenzie out of it because he gets spooked by someone coming up behind him.
Farrell's kick trickles over the back. Woodcock, strong tackle. Doing a good job of trying to lock the ball in. A little bit of push and shove off the ball as they get into Marshall as well. There's the strong tackle from Woodcock. Tackle count already 29-16 in favour of Port. They've got an appetite for work at the moment. Here's Marshall once more. Two hands to it. Couldn't complete the mark. Trengove around the body to no one in particular. And the mark's going to be taken here by Andy Ott in the last line of defence. Almost 14 minutes played here in the second quarter. And again, it's a wasteful entry inside 50 for Port, who had 29 inside 50s to 16 and still find themselves behind on the scoreboard where it counts.
Jack Trengrove keeping the statisticians quite busy with already 13 disposals. It's crazy to think that he was captain of the Melbourne Football Club when he was such a young player. And then the career he's had, you think he'd be in his late 30s. He's been around forever, but still such a young man, averaging 33 disposals in the league this year, though.
Wilson goes inboard. Garner, heavy contest there. Look at the speed here. It's terrific from Matthews. Kick going forward to McKenzie. He's going to lead press to the line and take it out.
That's better from Adelaide. Even if it's a kick to space, it's better than being an intercept mark.
Ned McHenry getting cleaned up here by Garner. Eyes for the ball though, but he's coming straight to the boundary line. So that's not a good sign for Ned McHenry. 19-year-old. There's a boundary throw in. Adelaide pressing. Been more efficient in front of goal so far with their inside 50s. This time we've got stalemate developing. Look at Fogarty. He's trying to wrestle his way off the canvas and out of the competition. Such a beast of a man. Laddams uncontested in the ruck. And he streaks away from them. How about that from the big man? The kick, not his best effort. But he gets it out wide. Clean bowled there was Andy Otten. Frandman goes back with it. Now he's got some problems. Needs support. Hand pass. Well done, Mays. Gets it to Davidson. Inside. Half volley from Woodcock was outstanding. Well, this has been better. Mays now. Lead comes. And they work it over the back. Marshall. Best position here. Gets there first. Dispossessed. Strong tackle. Good work from Boyle there. And he comes again. And they get it out of the danger zone through Chase Jones. It was heavy weather. And Stengel just barrels a little further forward. Hewitt needs help. Got a teammate there, McKenzie. Now it's Sutcliffe. And that's a neat kick as well as he finds the teammate. And Cam Hewitt wants to go across to Frederick, who's out in space.
And he's off to Frederick. He lowers the eyes, lowers the kick, and it goes straight over the chest of Matty Wright. So another turnover. Matty Wright's kick is good to press to his advantage. He can run, but he hasn't got anyone in 50. working down there is Stengel now to try and provide a contest. Been taken out by Sutcliffe. It'll kick off the ground. McKenzie on the left. Good kick too. Nice clearing kick. He's got Attlee. Plucks out Trengove. Up to 15. Trengove now. Up to 14 rather. Kick going forward now. And in a really good position there is Tobin Crocs. It was a great kick. Came from Farrell.
And this is exciting footy, up and back. Port Adelaide on the outer side really had a good opportunity, and then it took some strong defence. But Tobin Cox with the ball weighted nicely to his advantage and does the right thing. And again, this is a difficult shot at goal. And 9 marks last week versus the Bulldogs out of the Ponderosa. 25 goals, 12 this year. And hopefully he can bend this back, because Port Adelaide have been doing a lot of work just to hang on to the footy. They need to capitalise on this work rate.
Cox with 5 goals against the Crows back in round 7, the game that Adelaide won. And this kick is spot on. He drills it through. The Maggies are in front.
This little double cobra celebration there to the crowd. And well, they rebounded strongly out of their defensive 50, Port Adelaide. Moved it to the outer side. They had a good contest up there again from Toddy Marshall, who's looks like he's grown another gear, grown another leg tonight. He's been super quick inside their forward 50. But then it again rebounded back in from Cam Hewitt, who provided the defence. And sharpening up those kicking skills, but a long way to win the game. On the drive here was another rebound out of their defensive 50, Port Adelaide, and catching the Crow defenders out. Tobin Cox with a beautiful finish on goal to get his first for the night.
Fogarty into the ruck for Adelaide at 191 centimetres, up against Sam Hayes at 203. He's giving away 12 centimetres there. Appleton, hand pass disrupted. Wilson got there before Hayes. They come again though. Now chance for Attlee. Low pass. Oh, it's hot. Good hands there from Woodcock to take the mark. He's got the ball out wide. But going back with a flight of the ball, brave stuff from Matty Wright trying to lift as the captain. Farrell somehow manufactures a hand pass, ball in dispute, knocked away there by Matt Merritt. Good pressure again from Matty Wright as he drags down Sam Mays. This has been a great captain's knock at the Adelaide Oval. From Matty Wright, as we go to Andrew Hayes.
Yeah, Case, we're seeing Ned McHenry get ready to come back onto the ground. Of course, that collision a few minutes ago really knocked the wind out of his sails. So he was in the hands of the trainers. They did some tests and looks like no bumps and bruises, just perhaps a little windy.
Sam Hayes and Garner combined to Hewitt. The outer wing, Port. Just hit the front, so they're up by a point now. Jared Leanit started the game with the first goal in the opening couple of minutes. Goes back to Garner. He's got some support. Just traverses right across the ground. And Tom Corcoran hasn't got much on offer at the moment, though. Needs some movement, so decides just to go across to McKenzie. Crows set up structurally. Biggles pretty good at the moment. Port can't work their way through.
Yeah, they've been patient, though, Port Adelaide. Joel Garner was the man who cleaned up Ned McHenry, and they've considered him for a leadership role or a future leader down in Alberton. And today he's been pretty composed with that left boot of his.
Good grab by Woodcock, gives it to McKenzie. He goes long and hard through the hands. Little chance there for Laddams. Gets his way through the big man, and his vision is terrific.
He's up and about, Peter Laddams. His clearance out of the defensive 50 about 5 minutes ago, where he just left the on-balls around him. And have a look at him here, weaving in and out of traffic and then just balance himself. He looks like he's men against boys out there at the moment, having a ripping game so far. Nine disposals.
Very, very good work there by Laddams. Looked like he may not have even got a gig next year the way he came into the season, but he's had a brilliant season. And this kick now looks good. Sammy Mays gets his second.
Look at Peter Adams go here. Weave in and out, shrug a tackle, and find Sam Mays on the outer side, who finishes off the Port Adelaide great play. 34 disposals versus the Doggies last week, and tonight he started well again, Sam Mays.
Port Adelaide starting to assert their authority. That multi-pronged attack is providing plenty of headaches here for Adelaide at the moment. They kick five goals, Port Adelaide, and four of them have been from marks inside 40 metres. So Adelaide with plenty of defending to do as Lachie Scholl drives them out wide. Matty Wright's got it and wheels around quickly, and it was a good option. And it's a well-weighted kick to Gallucci. And Gallucci ran off his mark. Running back toward the goal square, Pat Wilson. And also going back there, Stengel. And it might have a carry. Oh, great job, Tom Corcoran. Just got a hand on it. Knocks it through for a minor score. And Adelaide moved to 4-3-27. Trailing Port Adelaide 5-3-33. 22 and a bit minutes played here, term number two.
Patrick Wilson's got that extra stomp in his step at the moment. He's not happy with a bit of treatment around stoppage, and it was wide open then, and Gallucci just missed him.
Yeah, strong hands by Andy Otten. Good kick too. Given back here to Boyle, and his kick, he was looking for Wilson, cut off by Attlee. Fires out a handball in Sutcliffe's direction, goes just a little bit further to Farrell.
Great tackle from Pahulky.
Morn team, forward footy trivia, Red Biglands, who holds the record for the most goals in a SANFL final for Adelaide? Greenwood, Deer, Beach or Menzel? We'll let you mull over that for a moment as Drew gets his way through traffic, pops the kick up. Otten leading the race back for it with Frampton. Andy Otten, just a little tap, was a good one, but it wasn't trapped in time. Laddams goes, runs and finishes!
For the contest here, Port Adelaide stay within it. Peter Laddams changes gears, 200 centimetres of him, and the former Norwood player just drills it after five AFL games this year. He is smoking hot for the start of this match.
16 goals, five this season. 80% conversion rate for him. Outstanding for the big man. Free kick going Adelaide's way here. And Himmelberg with it. His kick just slides off the side of the boot. Asks a lot of Jordan Boyle. Has to clean up the mess by retreating almost a half back. Andy Otten. His kick out wide. He wants Wilson right there with him. Sutcliffe. Good battle between them. And Sutcliffe diffuses it out of bounds. Morn team forward footy trivia for Rhett Biglands. Who holds the record for the most goals in a sample final for Adelaide?
Well, I remember Jono Beach kicking a big bag. The West Adelaide champion who's out with a knee. Finished off the rest of this season, and it was a big bag, two of seven or eight, I think. I'm going to go with C.
Good boy, Biggles. It was seven, and it was in the 2016 first semi against South Adelaide.
And this year, in the 6 years the sample have had Port and Adelaide Crows in, only the second time Adelaide have made the finals. Port Adelaide have made four out of six and two grand finals, which they've lost by a combined total of 5 points. So close to the boundary line, Laddams can't complete the mark and will have a boundary throw-in. Took over 25 minutes played here in the second quarter. Port Adelaide's kicked the last three goals of the game and five of the last six. And they started this quarter leading by two in the possession count, and it is now up to 38. They've had it on their terms here in term number two.
Laddams again wants to get moving, gives it to Drew back to Trengove. Top of the square. Best position was Marshall. Big thump over the back. Hands from Merritt. Hayes. Himmelberg. Here's McHenry now. Just goes with a little kick and it's going to roll out over the line, and he's not happy too. McHenry and Frederick. A little bit of heat. Last possession out of bounds. So Joel Garner.
Just get it to Peter Adams. He's gone into beast mode now. He's ripping everything out of stoppage, and it's getting up with him now.
Here he goes. Look at the big fella. Picks it up off the ground. Gives out a handball. Comes to Frampton. Going back. Best position, Matty Wright.
12 disposals in a half, Peter Adams. And nine of those contested. Dominating the hitouts with 15 and already kicked a goal.
Ball out wide. Mark taken by Pahulky. Had a couple of games at AFL level. Best player for Adelaide last week against South with 26 disposals and seven clearances. And he drives up towards centre wing. High flyers. Well, McAdam says he was pushed out of it, but he was just better read by Cam Hewitt, who takes the mark at centre wing and can drive Port Adelaide back inside their attacking 50. No one can complete the mark. Siren in the background. 27 minutes in that term. And after scores were level at quarter time when it was 3-1 apiece, Port Adelaide kicked 3-1 in that second quarter and now enjoy a 12-point buffer here. Adelaide led by 12 at one stage in the first term, but it's Port Adelaide by 12 here at the major break. And one wonders about Adelaide's capacity to keep this in check at the moment, because Port Adelaide dominated possession in that term.
That was great work rate from Port Adelaide. Just needed to get some reward for that hard work. And that's what they were doing all over the ground, providing not only pressure in their front half, but defensive pressure and ball movement has been right on the level. And they just have to make sure that they get reward for all of that effort, because they've been working so hard to maintain possession. And I think their forwards have justified that, as well as their defence. Well, Drew's had 17 disposals. Trengove with 16. McKenzie's been instrumental across halfback with 15 also.
Andrew Hayes is down on the boundary.
Thanks a lot, Soda. Joined by Cam Sutcliffe. Cam, it's been an arm wrestle throughout the whole of it, but started to break open just a little bit late in that second quarter.
Yeah, it has been a bit of an arm wrestle. We knew they'd bring the heat pretty early, and you know, just had to weather that storm a little bit, and we're hoping it would open up in the second half.
Geez, you're getting some serious service in the middle. Sam Hayes looks good, but Pete Laddams is having a serious game.
Yeah, I suppose it's good you have two big guys, and they don't really have a ruckman today, so you know, we need to take advantage of that and hopefully get on top.
Appreciate your time, mate. Best luck in the second.
Thank you.
There he is, Cam Sutcliffe, running around doing a job on Paddy Wilson, and at halftime it is Port Adelaide by 12 points. Time here of our qualifying final. 3 apiece in the first term. Then Port Adelaide were able to kick 3-1 in that second quarter. Willem Drew getting plenty of the footy, as is Jack Trengove. A couple of goals to Sam Mays and Matty Wright, Wilson, Lockie Scholl, all amongst the footy there for the Crows. And Biggles, what was really an impressive second term there by Port Adelaide after? Was it a really tight tussle in that first one?
I thought they controlled the footy, the Magpies, but they certainly spent a lot of energy controlling that footy. We see Leanit here just launching one to get the game underway. And Port Adelaide, well, they were pretty controlled across their half-back line. Adelaide were good out of their clearances. Even though they're undermanned in there at the moment, they're down a ruckman, they provide a lot of pressure around those clearances. But the pressure inside the Port Adelaide attacking 50 was brilliant. Tackling pressure, perceived pressure, and really getting at the defence of Adelaide, causing turnovers. And they capitalised in that first turn by kicking 3 from turnovers. And have a look at Peter Adams go. The big 200-centimetre giant booting a left-foot goal that he loved. And so did his teammates.
Yeah, he is in ripping form. He has just had a wonderful season and has now obviously inked himself a longer-term deal at the Power and be a big part of their plans, you would think, with Paddy Ryder going. Now, Biggles, when we have a look at his work too, he's got 4 clearances. So he's the number one clearance player on the ground for the big guy. Let's have a look at the Crows' goals. They did get 3 in that first term and then just the 1 in the second.
So Chase Jones getting them on the board early, started in at the centre bounce, and he has got a really crafty left foot. Now, it's great to see as well McAdam getting on the end of a couple. They're shorter presenting up players who are like to get on the lead and making their Port Adelaide defenders accountable. So we're going to need to see more of this in the second half if Adelaide are to hang in, because they love the lead-up style of play. And Tyson Stengel as well has been pretty good so far in this match. I just need his consistency to come throughout this match. We don't want him fading in and out of games, and his work rate will be right up there in the second half.
Because this is our second final, of course, of the SANFL series. The first one earlier today, the elimination final, and look, it was a remarkable game. Now, Sturt did go down by 14 points, but it was just one of those tough games because Nord were actually out by 38 points at one stage.
It was an awesome game. The closest elimination final in 7 years, and when we had over 31 goals kicked for the game, and whenever you thought that Sturt were out of the match, they just came back in, and it was really stry for stry. But the song was belted out by the Red Leg Army, and did they sing it loud and proud.
And the blue, every heart is true for the red and the blue. Well, Jared, take us through that. So many twists and turns, and you end up on the right side.
We spoke about it before the game. Like, finals against good teams, there's momentum shifts in games. We played some really good footy, then they played some excellent footy as well, and we just were able to hang on in the end. But, you know, I think we had 30-plus shots on goal. We probably didn't make the most of those opportunities where Sturt didn't miss, which kept them in the game to a certain extent. But I thought both teams had a real crack. It would have been a good game to watch if you weren't the coach, that's for sure.
Mate, it certainly was very entertaining. Take us through, I suppose, your season in general. You started on fire. After about five rounds, it looked like no one was going to get absolutely near you. They caught up to you. Yep. Now where do you stand going forward?
I think our best footy is definitely good enough. And I think we've shown that during the year when we play the footy we want to play for long periods of time. We're really hard to play against. Unfortunately, this year it's come and gone a little bit, up and down. And even today, like, I thought we had some really good momentum at times and probably got a little bit lazy with some structures and defensive effort and transition. And that got Sturt back into the game. But I thought, I was really proud that they were able to get themselves back into it after half-time and get the momentum back again. But, yeah, it was just a really good game of footy.
You have absolute X factor in spades. Anthony Wilson had his moments, but Dom Barry, that's the reason you recruited him?
Without doubt. Like, obviously, he's an elite player. He's an elite runner. Like, not many people would know, but he's at the highest end in regards to your GPS numbers and things. His sprint efforts are through the roof. He's got really good finishing skills in front of goal, and we needed that in our front half with Simon Phillips retiring as well. So, he was awesome today. He could have probably kicked 7 or 8, really. Anthony Wilson just does things that other people can't do, and Dylan Stevens at the end there just showed what sort of class he's got as well. So, overall, though, it was a really good team performance.
Obviously a fantastic result. If anything, is there anything you need to work on?
Yeah, I think just stay in the game for longer periods, and that's more about structure and more about just defensive transition. We probably got a little bit lazy in the second half of the second quarter, and when we had a really good momentum and got 4 or 5 goals up. So just the concentration to play harder for longer, probably, yeah.
Well, you're right, mate. It was very entertaining to watch. Best of luck for the rest of the finals campaign. Congrats.
Appreciate it. Thanks.
Yeah, there he is. Jared Cotton, of course, Brady Dore, Dom Barry, Anthony Wilson, all kicking 3 goals each, and they will take on the loser of this game. Right now, it is Port Adelaide up by 12 points at halftime. Well, here at halftime, it is Port Adelaide up by 12 points in the qualifying final. It's been, very tight first quarter. Port Adelaide just able to break it open a little bit. Biggles and our Powerade breakthrough player of the week from last week. We're going to award that now. They pick up a slab of Powerade, go in the running for the $2,000 at the end of the year for the breakthrough player of the year. And it's the Pooch, Josh Patillo.
What a transfer he's been since crossing over from Footscray. He leads the league in contested marks. The big man, all 200 centimetres of him, and had an outstanding game here against the Bays. Was a goal kicker this afternoon in the elimination final as well. And he'll take home that slab of Powerade, the Pooch. And he's a cult favourite down only as well, isn't he?
He absolutely is. He took some good marks again today to try and keep Sturt in that contest in that elimination final. And our Channel 7 goal of the week every Wednesday night on 7 News, John Casey has his SANFL segment. We always see the goal of the week. And this is Scotty Lewis in his final game.
The 200-game veteran, what a way to finish off, breaking out of the middle. And, he's going to make a lot of money in the country footy somewhere, I would have thought, Scotty Lewis, but has had a remarkable career for Wood West Tigers, a premiership player.
From inside the centre square, he launched that too. There is the Adelaide Oval at night, and it is Port Adelaide leading by 12 points here in the qualifying final. Second half coming up next on 7.
Welcome back to the Adelaide Oval. Halftime here and Port Adelaide leading by 12 points. And Statewide Super, always a wonderful partner of the SANFL again this season, supporting junior footy. And the Statewide Super Mini Leaguer of the Week, Andrew Hayes, has one up-and-coming South Australian superstar with him now.
Well, this is the second edition of the Statewide Super Mini Leaguer of the Week. Very happy to announce that I'm joined by Hannah Mills from the Jepps Cross Footy Club. Hannah, that is yours. Let's get that around your neck as you're a champion. Congratulations. Now let's get to know you. You love football. What's your favourite position?
Rover in the middle.
So you get heaps of touches, obviously.
Yeah.
All right. Who's your favourite SANFL side?
North.
North went very well last year. Struggled a little bit this year. Favourite SANFL player?
Lauren Daniel.
She is an absolute superstar. Let's play some hypotheticals. I'll give you $1 million. What do you do with it?
I don't know.
It's a tough call.
Yeah.
I'll let you stew on that one, but someone else told me as well that when you grow up, you want to be a police officer?
Yeah, I do.
Excellent. That is outstanding news. Good luck with that. Congratulations on the award. And give us a bit of a tip. Who wins tonight, Port or the Crows?
Crows.
Crows. That was a definite answer, Soda.
Good on you, Hazy and Hannah. Statewide Super. If you'd like to find out about the Mini League, make sure you contact your SANFL club. And a huge thank you to Statewide Super, who do wonderful things to support the community and our football.
Hannah certainly knew her female footballers. And speaking of female footballers, Greg Phillips, a Port Adelaide superstar of the past, he's taking on coaching Smosh West Lakes in the women's competition and got them all the way into the grand final. So he's done a great job of that. And as we mentioned a little earlier, all the SANFL clubs are playing finals in the juniors and the girls and women at the moment. So good luck to all of those that might be playing again tomorrow, including my son Archer and down at Smosh West Lakes and the... Under-14s are playing in the prelim final. They got their hands full there, but we wish them well and wish everyone well who's playing in finals over the weekend and ahead.
Great shout-out, Case. And there is a good connection with Smosh West Lakes as well, with Darren Mead, who used to coach down there as well. His son, of course, Mitchell Mead, is an up-and-coming star.
Absolutely. All Australian. Mitch Mead, was he at under-18 level, I think? May well have been, but a very talented young man. Now, looking at Port Adelaide right now, they lead by 12 points. So in that second turn, they were able to add 3-2 to the Crows, 1-2. And we saw Sam Mays get another one. Pete Adams is just in scintillating form, and Tobin Cox as well amongst them. And for the Crows, was Tyson Stengel, was the only goal kicker for them in that term. And it came in the opening minute of that second quarter. Here's John Casey to kick us off in the second half.
Ready to go in the second half. Port Adelaide by 12 points. Adams in the ruck up against Himmelberg. Wins the tap. Willem Drew finds it on the ground. Unconventional kick, but gets it going forward with the left leg. Otten wrestling with Frampton. No whistle forthcoming. And now Sutcliffe goes off the ground to his own advantage. He tracks it back. Wilson right there with him. Needs help. Mays provides it. Outside of the right boot to the hot spot. Top of the square. Hayes couldn't complete it. Under pressure there from Matt Merritt, who did a good job. Chase Jones out a little wider. And the Adelaide Crows now with a chance to break some lines as Boyle gets it to Scholl. And onwards they move it for Holkey. And his gun are trying to put a stop to it, but Stengel's got it now for Adelaide. And they've got players available in the forward line as well, but they couldn't turn and get it there quickly enough. Now the lead comes out, and that's a good grab taken there by McAdam.
Some sharp ball movement again. Adelaide looking to get on the lead and honour those leads as well. So they're not hesitating when someone presents up. They're backing themselves in with these shorter kicks. And it certainly worked in the first term for the Adelaide Crows. And again here, Port Adelaide cannot afford to sag off the leading player.
McAdam, already a goal kicker here in the opening quarter. Let's fly from 48. Doesn't like it off the boot. Doesn't like it at all. And was lucky to even get a minor score there. It was wide right and through for a minor score. Crows move to 4-4-28, trailing Port Adelaide 6-3-39. Look at the restart. Back to the middle of the ground. But it's coming back inside the attacking 50 pretty quickly. Bounce, not a good one for Stengel. Well, good speed coming there from Chase Jones. And he hands over now for the dangerous Stengel for the finishing touch. Oh, great defensive pressure. We'll step Trent McKenzie again. Garner gets it out wide. Good contest at the moment. Will Hamill there following it back toward the boundary line ahead of Kane Farrell and now over the line.
McKenzie was the man who launched that 70-metre re-entry on that lethal left boot of his and then smothers as well. Great follow-up work from Trent McKenzie. Saved a certain goal for the Adelaide Crows. Certainly not ball-watching, stayed with the play and had a really good impact so far in this match.
Getting plenty of it at the moment, McKenzie, as Laddams had the clearance, but the free kick has been plucked out. It's going to go to Himmelberg.
This ruck infringement here, the umpire was a fair way off it and there was slight hands in the back against Himmelberg, who took the front spot and was probably justified with the free kick being paid.
16 hit-outs to Laddams, 4 to Himmelberg, and pumps the Crows into action, top of the square, but just there again is Trent McKenzie. He's having some sort of match, up to 17 touches already.
Hand pass under pressure though. Good work from Adelaide here. Garner's got problems. His hand pass. Well, it looked like a high tackle. Trengove is infringed here against Jordan Boyle. And the left footer can go back here and have a shot at goal.
Oh, that was...
He plays on around the body. Likes it off the boot as well. How about that? Jordan Boyle with a candidate for goal of the night.
But Trent McKenzie got into a little bit of trouble here. We're looking on the National Pharmacy's optical replay, and then prior to that, Boyle makes the umpire aware of the shrug over the shoulder. Really weird celebration with the unicorn on the head, but great goal from Boyle regardless.
He's third for the season. Boyle, it didn't have a touch of unicorn about it. Port Adelaide, Tobin Cox, doesn't bounce for him, goes for Merritt and spins around quickly. Frampton's want to see this over the line, and did he get a boot on it? If he didn't, it's going to be a Port Adelaide kick here. I think he might have just touched his boot. Yep, he's going to get a throw in.
Did it come off the boot or not? No. Really loving the work of Cam Sutcliffe at the moment. He's been designated the role to go up against Patrick Wilson. He's had 16 disposals, making Wilson accountable, who's only had the 12, so I've got a feeling that would have been highlighted on the whiteboard.
Kane Farrell's kick, top of the square, going back, Tobin Cox. We talked about his marking earlier in the game, and he's got a great set of hands for a little fella.
They're just staying in the clearances at the moment, Port Adelaide, whereas Adelaide were thinking that ball was going to dribble over the line. And some great follow-up work again from Mace, who got the position down there. And back to the top of the square, Tobin Cox has been pretty good so far tonight.
We saw him thread the needle in the first quarter with that goal that he did kick, the second quarter rather. So he's got one to his name so far. He did kick a handful against the Crows earlier in the year in round seven at Alberton when the Crows did get up. Here is his chance now. And well, an easier shot than he had in that second term, and he missed it. Andrew Hayes.
Yeah, so it's pretty important both sides to make the most of their opportunities, because the rain is starting to come down now and plenty more rain forecast over the next hour or so. So goals might be at a premium.
Oh, clanger from Pierce Seymour from the restart. He kicked it straight back to Tobin Cox. Just didn't get enough on the kick. And Tobin Cox will have a chance now to make amends. He's had a sighter. Ball drop wasn't not exactly what he was after in the last attempt. And a chance now for Tobin Cox to double the lead for the Port Adelaide Magpies. They lead by 6 points. And that one, he's pushed it way to the right. He's got the yips at the moment. And these might come back to haunt Port Adelaide. They've been dominating the inside 50s. It's 39-20 inside 50s. And Port Adelaide, 11 scoring shots to 9, just haven't been efficient enough. From the restart, they all go down. Laddams and Drew collide. Himmelberg in traffic. Shrugs the Appleton tackle. Darcy Fogarty gets it on. McHenry, he goes long. Frederick, well positioned, comes from behind, but that's a good grab. Nice mark taken by Chase Jones. And the efficient Adelaide Crows are going forward once more. They want Stengel in the pocket, got two hands to it, tried to keep it alive. And now McKenzie, close to the goal line, slow hand pass, Trengo. They're playing with fire here at the moment, the Magpies. Ellsworthy, he scurries it toward halfback. Marshall turns around, not a lot to kick to. Good contest provided there by Sam Davidson, got a fist on it. But it stays inside the boundary line. Matt Merritt, his handball over the top. The Crows just trying to get something happening here at the moment. Scholl involved. And now they work it all the way back to Merritt once more. And his kick is high. Himmelberg has to stand underneath it. And Marshall went high and came down a little proppy as well, just clutching his right ankle. Keep an eye on that as Laddams feeds at Sutcliffe. Low kick to no one in particular. Scooped up by Pierce Seymour, who barrels it forward once more. Matty Wright pushed to the ground there by Jack Ellsworthy. He'll win a free kick.
Well, there's plenty of heat around the contest. This is game on here. Adelaide have started the second half with a bit of ferociousness about them.
Matty Wright goes in with his kick, cuts across. Handball from Appleton, comes out to Corcoran, and he's just overcooked it a little bit, which invited Lockie Scholl into the contest. Close to the line, Attlee works through well. His kick to advantage of Crows. Ryan with it at halfback in defence, just switches it across. Gallucci, he wants to get things moving. He takes it further across the ground now. He's got Boyle. Has a look up, just tries to draw some players towards him, and the kick just didn't have enough on it. And cut off there by Todd Marshall. Matty Wright was the target.
Great recovery from Todd Marshall. Just gave the ankle a little twinge, but made sure he stayed with the play to intercept that one. Leading disposal get on the ground at the moment is Cam Sutcliffe with 18 disposals. McKenzie's had the same as well, 18 for Adelaide. Lockie Scholl with 14, copped a nasty hit just down in front of us just only moments ago.
Trengove just pokes it forward. Only as far as Jordan Boyle, though. His hand pass was a good one to the advantage of Scholl. And now Andy Otten joins in and he drives up the line at the back. Oh, slipped through the fingers there of Tom Corcoran. And a chance now for Tom Hutchison. Gives it to Wilson, who jams it onto the boot. Top of the square. McAdam lurking with intent. McKenzie right there with him. Frederick arriving as well. And they force it through for a minor score. And Adelaide moves to 5-5-35. Trailing Port Adelaide 6-5-41 here. And we played 9 and a bit minutes, term number 3.
That's a great battle at the moment. McAdam going up against McKenzie. And certainly when it's on the deck, it's in favour of McAdam. McKenzie having the strength in the air, though.
Marshall combines with Trengove. His kick in towards the centre of the ground. Scholl, the first one, back onto it. He's going to lead the race. He's trying to get some support. Looks around, turns, and the kick is a good one, too. Paddy Wilson in the centre of the ground. Goes along the number one possession getter for the Crows at SANFL level, Wilson. Stengel's clever. He works his way around. He's 54 out, drops the kick in, looking for McAdam, but strong hands. McKenzie again.
Great job, as identified by Rhett Biglands in the air. McKenzie's got McAdam's measure. The Trengove, not a lot to kick to, so he's short and to the left where he finds Garner. Frampton's up the line, but he's a little inconvenienced at the moment. He pulled up Proppy from the last play phase. Slow just to get back into the scheme of things. So the ball over the back. Willem Drew with support. Here's Frampton. Going to go off the ground here, and it's a good option. Got it to Laddams. Lead comes now, and the pass is a good one, and Tobin Cox takes the mark ahead of Lockie Ryan there. He can go back, although he'd be a little gun-shy at the moment. His last two attempts have been woeful.
Yeah. Tobin Cox, I think, has been watching a bit of Matty Richardson at the Legends game the other night where the radar was completely off target by about 50 metres. Tobin Cox is a very good shot at goal, though, as Richo was in his prime. Hard man to stand, Matty Richardson. Only had the one game on him and certainly slept well that night after he had 20-odd marks.
One goal, two to his credit so far. This will be an adventure, Tobin Cox. He comes forward. Drop pump with a right boot, sprays it across the face, and lucky to get a minor score. This is quite surprising because coming into this game, Tobin Cox had kicked 25 goals, 10 at 75%, and he's missed three very gettable chances there, and it could come back to haunt the Magpies.
He's got the yips at the moment as Seymour brings it in for Adelaide. Matty Wright, good hands too. Former leading goal kicker at Carlton. Just chips it in, centre of the ground, Tommy Hutchison. Play some good footy as a top-up player. Game number 14 for him in the Crows gear this year. Darcy Fogarty, seen him in the ruck even tonight as well as doing his work up forward to Adelaide. Just being patient at the moment.
It's a good pick-up, though, Case, with their inaccuracy, Port Adelaide at the moment.
Kick from Boyle goes in. Turning around was Fogarty. Pahulke in trouble there with Mays. Flicked out a handball. Garner hacks it out of the pack. Andy Otten on his own looks up, and the kick, though, is not a good one. Lean it, and his kick can't quite get the distance of Trengove. Just mucking around with it at the moment, and Lean it's kick out of bounds on the full. Just as he was kicking, he was knocked. So there's going to be an opportunity now for James Matthews. Goes in with the kick. It's a good one, too. On the lead is McAdam.
Pinpoint pass from Matthews. That's the instinct that Adelaide have been really good at so far tonight, in that they've been one-step kick. They haven't been hesitant with their disposal by foot. When there's been a lead on, they've honoured it. And really nice pass. And you can't stop that as a defender, even no matter how good a form McKenzie's in.
McAdam goes with the banana and right across the face of the goal mark taken by Sam Hayes.
Deep in the back pocket. Try and relieve some pressure. Inside 50 count. 40 to Port Adelaide. 27 to the Crows. The inefficiency of Port Adelaide in attack has left the door open here for Adelaide. Middle stages of the third quarter. Himmelberg over the ball. Marshall right there with him. Paddles it forward. Will Hamill gets the ball right. Dragged off it by Willem Drew. Most incorrect disposal. Strong body work there as the ball's knocked down out of bounds. More Mourne team forward footy trivia for Rhett Biglands. Thomas Seymour Hill, whose name adorns the Premiership Trophy, began as an administrator at which SANFL club? Port Sturt North or Norwood? Thomas Seymour Hill.
Can't see it home, but it's a look of bewilderment on Rhett Bigland's face right now.
This is going to be a very much a stab in the dark, I guess.
I do apologise, as much as I love the Thomas Seymour Hill Cup. I've got no idea.
Oh, well, you're a 25% chance.
Here we go. Kane Farrell. His kick into attack. Andy Otten running back with Billy Frampton. Frampton ends up with it. Appleton to Frampton. He's going to be run down by Pahulk. He gets his kick just in time to Sutcliffe. He hurries his into the top of the square. Pete Laddams in good position. Desperation from Corey Davey. The late inclusion. Knocks it through from behind.
Well, I would have thought... I'm not sure if Thomas Seymour Hill knows how many times that cup has been drank out of and what sort of things have happened with that cup. But I'm just going to have a stab in the dark at D here, Norwood, because they're a traditional old club.
Oh, winner!
Oh, well done.
Well done, Biggles.
That was pure luck, not genius.
Well, Norwood won today, so that was a good omen.
Ah, yes.
14-point winners over Sturt if you've joined us late. 16-14 to 15-6, Norwood won. Closest elimination final since 2012. And again, the inefficiency going into attack for Port Adelaide. That was diabolical as Jordan Boyle was able to mark uncontested. And gets it to Pat Wilson now. Margin at 8 points. The biggest margin we've seen at any stage has been 12. And that was to Adelaide in the opening quarter on the back of three unanswered goals. And then a 12-point lead at halftime on the back of three unanswered goals for Port Adelaide. Lena did well. Strong at it. Holds the ball aloft. Hand pass at close quarters for Davidson. He was a little undecided. And the ball deflected out of bounds. So we'll have a boundary throw-in. 15 and a half minutes played. Term number three. Port Adelaide in attack.
Just to add to that discussion about the inaccuracy. In round 17, when Port played Sturt, they only won by 15 points. That was super inaccurate. It kept the double blues in it. Just keeps that door ajar. And they probably should have kicked three or four more goals tonight, Port Adelaide, and they want to make the most of them, particularly in this type of final.
Just the one goal kicked in this term. It was by Boyle for the Crows, just 3 minutes in. So coming up to the 16-minute mark now, and the handball comes out wide. Pressure from Garner comes back to him. Big tackle from Fogarty on Garner. Eight points now the margin for Port Adelaide. Hayes, ruckwork, little tap over the back. Jones, McHenry. Jones is the future of Adelaide, really, when you look at Jones and McHenry working together there. Himmelberg gives it off to Hutchison. He's got a runner in Pahulki. Quick kick, hurried forward, and it just went out of bounds. Didn't get touched, so chance for Trent McKenzie to get things moving quickly for Port.
Perfect delivery for Trengove as well. The spread is on. Jack Ellsworthy makes ground. Trengove looking beyond that. Lead comes now, and he hit it too hard. Cleared Frampton. Otten wins a free kick against Cam Sutcliffe. 17 free kicks for Adelaide, 12 for Port. Mentioned them early on. There was a lot of free kicks paid in the first quarter and a bit. That's quietened down in that category as Otten drives long. McKenzie was there, fell to the ground. Stengel is there, looking dangerous. Kicks against Frederick around the body. How about that from Tyson Stengel? And Adelaide are back within 2 points.
Have a look at the front and centre on the National Pharmacy's optical replay from Tyson Stengel. Got out of there, broke out of the stoppage, and that is a great snap on goal. Finished the SANFL season, seventh on the Ken Farmer medal tally, and that'll excite the fans.
32 goals for the year. He's second for the night. Stengel, the number one goal kicker for the Crows. He's spent some time in the midfield this year as well just to get his engine up and ready for AFL football. Dangerous player, and we're within 2 points now. Port Adelaide lead. Gallucci, his kick is not bad. Hewitt's reaching around the front with a punch on Jackson Press. Fires it back to McKenzie. Big high kick. Clearing one. Out of wing, sitting under it was Frampton. He's had Otten all night, wearing pretty tightly. He's done a good job, Andy. Laddams, he's done a terrific job with Port Adelaide in the ruck. Kick from Mays goes forward. A little bit of a wobbler. Boyd Woodcock couldn't mark it. Coming down with it in the air was Corey Davey. High kick now, pouncing. Looks like it's a good kick, but just didn't have enough on it getting around Tobin Cox.
One goal four for Tobin Cox. That one looked like it had enough height and shape on the ball to get it around, but from his nine disposals, he sort of could have had three or four.
Seymour restarts, this time with safety, going for distance. Good work there from James Matthews. It's quite an enigma as a player, Matthews, but his kick on the favourite Joel Garner, who's happy to bring it to ground and escort it over here. Approaching time on in the third quarter. Two goals in this term for Adelaide. Port Adelaide, well, they are yet to add a goal. They've kicked five behinds in this quarter. Adelaide has kicked two goals too. The 12-point halftime lead has been reduced to just three. Ruck, good work from Hayes there. He fell to the ground, still got a tap on it. Lean it. Atley, excellent hand pass. Didn't have to break stride there. It was Tom Corcoran, and his kick's a good one to Sutcliffe, who turns, plays on. Lead from Marshall. Oh, that's pretty to watch. From one side of the ground, from half back to half forward. Oh, that was excellent teamwork from the Magpies.
And great work out of stoppage as well. Leadership from Willem Drew. There was two loose Adelaide defenders on the defensive side of that stoppage. He yelled out to Appleton, make sure you pick up one of those. They pushed across, created an extra number. They got out of stoppage, swung out the other side, and some terrific hard-working run from Ken Sutcliffe to straighten them up.
So Marshall hasn't had his kicking boots on tonight with three behinds. They're overdue, Port Adelaide. And Marshall, I'm not even going to make the distance here. It's into the pocket, and Laddams is going to save them here, although he's on a tight angle, but he takes the mark. Well, they're kicking for goal. Oh, it's left a lot to be desired here, the Magpies. Now, Laddams going to work around the body here. 15-5 on the season. He makes no mistake. Get it to Peter Laddams, and good things happen.
This is great vision here. The ball drops short. Now, that was just pure strength from Laddams. He has been remarkable tonight with 18 disposals. 12 of those have been contested, followed up with tackles. There is every column on the stat sheet so far he has ticked, including 17 hit-outs, and most importantly, two goals.
Five clearances as well from the big fella. He's on fire at the moment. That's Port's first goal for the term as Atlee goes off the deck. Marshall and Cox getting involved there. Seymour flicks it up to Scholl, Hamill, and Adelaide out of trouble just momentarily, though. The kick couldn't get to Jones. Lean it. Goes off the deck now. Laddams providing the tackle. Seymour goes back to Otten. His kick is a good one, though, and it provides McHenry with a chance to clear it out of defence for good for Adelaide for the moment. 9 points the Maggies lead by.
Terrific vision there from Otten. The execution was outstanding. That's what you need in the back line. So they get it now from Merritt. He gets it out to Seymour. Short kick. Here's Gallucci. Been quiet, Gallucci, coming up for disposal number 8 here. Maybe expect a little more off him. And now Pat Wilson is coming up for disposal number 16. Signing for another 12 months with the Crows on a rookie contract yesterday. Look at the disposal from Wilson. Oh, good defensive pressure from Cam Hewitt there as he got the fist to it. And his teammates get around him. Locked it down.
We spoke about this in the pregame. The Adelaide love to get on the lead and honour those leads. And the defensive spool from Cam Hewitt there, he was absolutely in the back of his shorts, not letting him have any room at all. Brilliant spoil.
Drew to Appleton. He goes top of the square. Laddams got into a great position there. Couldn't take it. Sutcliffe off the deck. Doesn't get the roll he needs.
I had a chance to bend down and pick that up rather than try and make something out of nothing. We saw Stengel on the bench. Ryan and Hutchison are there with him. Adelaide pinned in their defensive zone at the moment. Out wide, Hayes puts the fist on Himmelberg, knocks it down out of bounds. Approaching the 24-minute mark of this third quarter. We've seen 28 minutes played in the opening term and then 27 in the second. A boundary thrown with Port Adelaide snatching the momentum here and a 10-point lead. After Adelaide had closed the margin to just 2 points. Drew, hard at it. Well done, Pajolki. Well, he's lost control of it now, though. Frederick right there with him. Tangle of arms and legs, and the umpire's going to come in and call for the ball.
Cam Sutcliffe now with 23 disposals, which is the equal most for Port Adelaide, and three clearances also.
Drew working through, gets it out to Trengove. Woodcock, just a little fumble. He's going to have some fun with Boyle at the moment now.
No, he's picked the wrong man. He's picked the wrong man, Boyd Woodcock. He is a very tough customer, Jordan Boyle.
Tough customer with some crazy sideburns on that haircut of his. I'm not sure what the kids are thinking these days. They're certainly not the sideburns you see in The Simpsons.
So the Adelaide Crows, can they grab a goal here and make it a really interesting contest? Matty Wright's got that on his mind. He barrels it forward. Chance now for Jackson Press. If he can pick it up cleanly, he does. Needs to shrug the tackle. Good pressure from Port Adelaide. McAdam, dispossessed. Oh, you've got to love the defensive pressure that's coming at the moment from Port Adelaide. But the mark's being taken. No, in fact, all play on. So umpire's going to come in and ball it up here just when Jackson Press thought he was going back for a shot at goal.
Corcoran was the man. He came in absolutely steaming. Terrific tackle, not only to provide the pressure, but to not give away a free kick. That was just outstanding.
Boholke works it to Seymour, the fullback. He's at the wrong end of the ground at the moment. High ball, and McAdam stands underneath it, takes the mark. And here's a chance for Shane McAdam to go back and kick his second goal of the game and drag the Adelaide Crows back to within 4 points.
Yeah, eyes on the footy. Protects the drop of the ball really well, Shane McAdam. And it was a nice contested mark. His uncle Adrian kicked 23 goals in his first three AFL games. And this will be a pretty handy one.
So McAdam, to shave the margin too, that didn't come off the boot well, did it? He's shaking his head. It wobbled forward and through for a minor score. So the goal kicking from both teams, neither of them in the positive. With Port Adelaide 7-9 and Adelaide 6-6 at the moment in near-perfect conditions, just not good enough.
Only 13 goals for the match so far. They're going to need to take their opportunities when they do come. Marshall, it's got McHenry, wrapped him up. Tackle count now, still Port Adelaide leading. Crows are working their way back in, 44-38 in that area. And clearance is 25-20, so Port plus five. Attlee has had six clearances. It's been terrific. Tough player as well. Boholke saw him play an outstanding game against South Adelaide earlier in the year with his five goals. Puts it up. Big punch at the back was from Marshall. Right into the direction of Boyle. He's got the chance now to get it through. I think the bouncers helped him out. Boyle has kicked his second goal for the term. And the Crows are right in reach now, just the 3 points behind.
There's a bit of luck there from Boyle. It was a good spoil from Marshall, just killed it. He was the only man out there. And Gary Ayres used to call that random variability. We used to call it Ronnie Burns. Wherever it falls, he was there. Just luck. Doesn't matter. Gets them back within reach. It's a really good finish.
Jordan Boyle, two goals tonight, and he kicked two all season coming into this game. Last year he played seven games and kicked five goals without a miss. So in his SANFL career here, Jordan Boyle has kicked 9 goals without a miss. And that's what they needed to do. 17 games, 9 straight. Here's Willem Drew. 28 minutes played here in the third term. Might be a lot of time left on the clock. And the margin cut to just 3 points here. Siren in the background, so we are set up for a fantastic final quarter. It is up for grabs here at three-quarter time. Port Adelaide 7-9-51, leading the Adelaide Crows 7-6-48. More live SANFL Statewide Super League here on Channel 7 in just a moment.
The finals are here. In the days ahead, new heroes will rise.
And it starts with a sudden death showdown. Eagles and Bombers on Thursday night footy. Then, a Friday night epic. Geelong and Collingwood at the MCG. And a Saturday doubleheader. Giants and Bulldogs, then Lions and Tigers.
Sensational!
The finals begin Thursday on 7.
All of this. Every ball.
Gone! Yes!
Every moment.
Absolutely superb!
It's our national sport when Australia stands together.
Oh, he's got it! Magnificent penalty!
Live, free, and in HD.
What a catch!
7. Your home for cricket every summer.
Show.
One goal six to Port Adelaide in that third term. The Crows 3-3. They are within 3 points. Certainly within striking distance. Trent McKenzie and Jack Trengove racking them up. Two goals to Laddams and also to Mays. Stengel and Boyle with two goals for the Crows. Let's head down to Andrew Hayes.
Thanks, Soda. Matty, still such a tight contest. How do you break it open?
Yeah, look, again, our ball use, won six that quarter, obviously hurt us and gave Adelaide a sniff. So, yeah, we've got a real fight on our hands in the last quarter.
It's not heavy, but it's consistent. The rain's there and the skills at times have been sloppy. Do you need to change your game style at all?
Yeah, we certainly spoke about that. We obviously need to change the way that we're going to play, get numbers to the contest and surge the ball forward a bit. So, yeah, it should be good last quarter.
Best of luck.
Thanks, mate.
We're ready to go in this final quarter. Spot on the second semi up for grabs here against Glenelg. The loser to face Norwood. Port Adelaide are the best final quarter team in the SANFL. They've won 15 out of 18. Can they bring it home here? As Hayes wins the ruck, Boholke sharks it though. And around the body, he gets the Crows going forward initially. McKenzie there to stifle it for the moment. Good work there from Hutchison. Frederick dragged down by Hutchison. Ball still in dispute. Farrell gets involved as well. Now it's at the back and off the ground. A chance here for the Crows. It's loose. Can they strike free? Gallucci dispossessed. Garner just happy to bang it out of the danger zone. But a good mark taken there by Lockie Scholl. And he goes into the pocket. McKenzie flies. Brought to ground. In fact, it was Trengove and a free kick there against Matty Wright for illegal use of the body.
A little bit of a tunnelling free kick there. Matty Wright just working Trengove under the footy. Lockie Scholl, he had a heavy collision in that second term right here in front of us in the Don Bradman grandstand and bounced back. He's been very courageous going in the footy in the air.
Trengove's up to 25 touches now, leads all comers on the ground. Wilson doing some work on the bottom. Davidson gets his handball out to Farrell. Gives it to, Hayes taken down. That's a terrific tackle and pressure from Lockie Ryan. He backs onto it again, gets another one to Otten. McHenry taps it to Himmelberg. His kick into the pocket. McAdam was the target. It's knocked through. So we'll get the ball thrown in. Port Adelaide by 3 points. Have a look at that by Ryan.
Great takedown. The pressure around the footy has been immense from Adelaide. Tackling pressure has been really good and have caused a couple of goals in that third term, Coles, from turnovers as well, so that pressure's been really good.
Flat throw in from the boundary umpire. Didn't give him Himmelberg much to work with there. Farrell pushed over the line, couldn't get a free kick. Umpire says no, bring it in. Oh, Farrell. Paddy Wilson frustrated as they've been tagging him all night and giving him plenty to think about. And he pushed Farrell over the line and was given the benefit of the doubt.
Great news with Port Adelaide supporters. Kane Farrell signing this week. The Bendigo boy. Signing on with the power for another couple.
Himmelberg takes front position, brings it to ground right, trying to milk a free kick. Umpire wasn't buying it. Wilson likewise trying to sell it. And Sutcliffe into Wilson again. Ball springs out the back, almost like a rugby move. Frampton front position. Otten gets a fist to it. High ball. Frederick did well there. Worked at the advantage of Appleton. It goes back to Frederick. Saw him kick arguably the goal of the year at Alberton earlier this season, Frederick. He can come up with the incredible. And Hutchison there, unable to keep it alive and inadvertently kicking the ball out of bounds. So we'll have a boundary throw in. 2.5 minutes played here in the final quarter. Game up for grabs.
If we just look at the third term in isolation, the Crows won the contested possession count 41-34. They both got a goal each from stoppage. The Crows got two goals from turnovers, so the pressure was right up on the level.
A contested possession count square for the whole night so far. 107, well, Port just picked up one, so 108. So Port a plus one in that area as Hayes looks for Frampton out in front, couldn't take it, had some pressure from Otten coming through. Farrell, his kick is a good one too, middle of the ground, finds Marshall, not a lot on offer, so he goes out wide to Mays, plenty of time, turn around and he'll drop it off to Frederick. He's got some speed here, Frederick. Let's see how he goes with Hutchison. Merritt slides in, fires a handball out. Hewitt sitting over the top of it. Drew goes to give it to Mays. Taken down the tackle by Boyle. Didn't he have a big third term? Kick two goals, Boyle. And he showed us, well, a new celebration. Look at the unicorn who debuted tonight.
The unicorn or the rhinoceros. Not sure what that type of move was, but regardless, he's got two goals. And terrific work there from Matty Merritt to leave his opponent and create a contest.
High ball. Marshall contests. Will Hamill found it on the ground. His hand pass is a good one for Lockie Ryan, although his kick's not good. And it's going to out of bounds before Otten can get there. So last possession restart. And Frampton could have a crack from here. Maybe Frampton, 10 disposals tonight. Get to have a scoring shot at goal. Kicked 7 last week in the big win at Central District. And 6 goals and was suspended when these teams last clashed at Port Pirie. So Frampton does take a crack at it. Cross the face of goal. They'll contest. High flyer there was Tobin Cox. And it's through for a minor score. And Port Adelaide move to 7-10-52, leading Adelaide 7-6-48 by 4 points, approaching the 5-minute mark of the final term.
Tony Lockett's been really good with his time throughout this match, having a chat to us in the second term and again there in the three-quarter time break. You can sense his frustration with the ball use, though. They've got to make sure they sharpen that area up.
The kick from Seymour to Hummelberg didn't work out well. Here goes Marshall. He's got a runner on the outside. It's Sam Mays. And he misses.
This is getting pretty frustrating from a Port Adelaide point of view. Only a better finish on goal. Had all the time in the world.
They are wasting chances here, Port Adelaide. It's going to be the 8th time this season in 19 games that they've kicked more behinds than goals, the way it's shaping at the moment. But Adelaide, well, they're pinned in their side. They're defensive 50. This man knows how to kick a goal. Sam Mays, he's kicked 3.
You just got the sense here the pressure would eventually result in a goal. And on the National Pharmacy's optical replay, Sam Mays obliges with that. Got his third for the night, 16 disposals, 7 inside 50s. And his pressure around the footy has been brilliant.
Kicked 3 goals, 12 coming into this game, and he's kicked 3 goals tonight. 3 of 8 has been a wonderful return as clearance comes out and mark taken by McKenzie. He's had a solid night as well, McKenzie. Kick is out towards Tringove, Himmelberg at the back, Boyle and Mays again. We'll see that.
They've worked so hard, Port Adelaide, to retain the footy. And going inside their attacking 50, the inside 50 count at the moment, 50-35. And whilst it's hard work for the Adelaide defenders to continue to try and rebound it, they will make the most of those inside forward 50 entries, but certainly they've been competitive around stoppage and their run from the back half has been good.
Hazen Himmelberg comes down to Drew, roves it beautifully. Kick up, direction of Laddams, couldn't finish it. Otten, back to Ryan, long handball. Marshall was there, not taken high, said the umpire. Frampton flicks out a little handball with Hamill, Seymour, and his kick only as far as this guy who is red hot at the moment. Sammy Mays with his 3 goals.
He's got the magnet on, and ball just following him wherever he goes. Shot on goal prior to his last goal was a gettable one. He had more time than what he thought. This one here is going to be right on his distance.
He'll be kicking just outside 50 as he lets fly. And I tell you what, with the rain, it was a good, good kick. Plenty of distance, but cannons into the post.
Had a terrific year. 18th in the league for disposals. Finished off the regular home and away season with a massive game, 34 disposals and 8 clearances out of the Ponderosa. And a lot of body strength to his clearance work as well.
2 years ago, he was top 5 in the Brisbane Lions, best and fairest. He's been in the top 10 a couple of times, so he's a high-quality player with plenty to offer. Sam Hayes, again, and Adelaide pinned inside their defensive 50. Marshall, the target, got underneath it. Loose ball. Well, overrunning it there was Chase Jones. Here's Sutcliffe, wrestles out of the tackle. Tobin Cox dragged down by Jones. The umpire's going to come in. That rain's starting to get a little heavier now. See Andrew Hayes perched under the Channel 7 umbrella down on the boundary line. 9 minutes played in this final quarter. Laddams couldn't control. It's going to be difficult to score goals from here. Well, that's a good grab from Farrell. A touch of class from him, and he's well within range here. His delightful left foot kick. The accuracy is going to be the question.
So Wise on the footy here, and it is slippery out there at the moment. But Jared Leenan's been setting up really well defensively for Port Adelaide. He's the loose across there. Now he instructed Farrell to go for the footy. Plenty of voice, and he's been a leader out there as well. He's a very experienced leader with directing others and setting up defensively.
Not his best effort. 12 goals in 12 games at SANFL level this season. For Kane Farrell, led their goal kicking last season with 21 goals for Port Adelaide in the SANFL. And that's out on the full. And that's the second time Port Adelaide have missed everything in the game.
Corcoran, a couple of bites at it, taken off the ball. Chase Jones working hard to hold that in there too. Andrew Hayes is on the boundary.
Good to see Jason Paul-Pleasure doing a bit of running for the Crows tonight. Of course, the fans would know him from his time at the Crows, 130 games from 2006 to 2014. May not see him running around in any capacity on a footy field in the future. Part of the MFS's latest intake. So he's next year going to be firing instead of the footy.
Tobin Cox gets the ball off the deck, takes the mark 40 metres out. And, well, his radar has been off to say the least. He's kicked 1-4 tonight and a couple out of bounds.
Goodness. His teammates to get around him there as well, Sader, and just say, take your time. We know you're a good kick. Good leadership being shown there by Todd Marshall to come over and just reassure him that they're completely confident.
Will and Drew pushing back into space. And speaking of leadership, his leadership around stoppage tonight, Will and Drew, has been exemplary. He's been organising other players as well as Cam Sutcliffe, getting them right in the right spots. And it's all the hard work in pre-season comes to fruition in finals.
25-10 for the season coming into this game. So 26-14 is his tally. And this kick is off again. So five behinds.
Well, it pushes the margin out to 13. And it's the biggest we've seen at any stage in the game. And 21 scoring shots to 13. Really, Port Adelaide should have put this game away, but it's 13 points. Middle stages of the final quarter. Still Adelaide looming. Close enough if good enough. Free kick's going to go to Laddams here. Undersized, the Crows have been forced into error. On that occasion, it was Fogarty, and he retreats here. Laddams is just a little proppy at the moment. Lean it with it. Not a lot on offer. He's just going to go for distance. Difficult to mark in the conditions. Marshall tries to work into the pack. Pierce Seymour got a hand on it. Now congestion around the ball. And we'll have another ball up.
Port Adelaide with a very clean bill of health. No injuries to speak of. Aidan Johnson copped a one-match ban, I think, for rough conduct. He may be the only player who can return if they are successful tonight. The LA Crows, they had someone out with a two-game suspension, wasn't it? Top of my head, it was
Ben Davis.
Ben Davis was the man. Thank you, Hazy.
Adelaide win the free kick here, going the way of James Matthews. He had 24 of the 36 players inside Adelaide's defensive 50 there for a moment. Here's Andy Otten getting it from Wilson, driving up the line, just wants to get it away from the danger zone. Going back with a flight of the ball. Peter Laddams has been outstanding tonight.
Yeah, in PlayStation 3 terms, he has gone into cheat mode tonight, Peter Laddams. He's gone to another level. Been outstanding, not only in the air, on the ground, his follow-up work and two goals as well.
Five clearances and 14 of his 20 possessions have been contested.
Didn't figure Biggles as a PlayStation man, Sada.
More of an Xbox.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
And an X-Factor at times.
Yeah, sore thumbs on both those consoles.
It's a good kick to Trengove. So in centre wing, Jack Trengove up to 26. Trent McKenzie has 27. For Port Adelaide, thumped forward in the direction of Pete Laddams. And a throw-in, so 13 minutes gone, 13 and a half nearly, and 13 points, a really handy lead for Port Adelaide. There's the top disposals on the ground. McKenzie, Trengove, Drew, Sutcliffe and Otten. And with this rain still coming down, it is a very, very handy lead of 13 points as Laddams goes to take it out of the ruck.
That's an excellent effort from Andy Otten as well, because he's on Billy Frampton, who is scoreless tonight. That was always going to be a pivotal matchup going into this game. The red-hot Billy Frampton, after his goal-kicking exploits out of the Ponderosa, and Andy Otten racking up plenty of touches and intercept marks.
Close to the boundary line. Well done, Attlee. Got it to Drew. Now lean it. Charging forward. Kick is wide. Tracking it back here, Sam Davidson. Oh, Andy Otten doing a great job. Came solidly, got there before Frampton, and now Frampton's got it, though. His kick around the body's a nice kick, and it finds Tobin Cox. Well, Tobin Cox, another adventure here, another shot at goal for him. He's kicked 1-5 tonight, and again, Marshall goes over him. I like that coming from Todd Marshall.
Billy Frampton having an influence there. And their forward line is nicely balanced with smalls and talls. And with Marshall having the agility up there and his competition in the air, he's also had 17 disposals. It just looks like it's gelling a lot better. But really difficult to match up on.
He's a long way back off the mark, Toby Cox.
It's a Ben Brown run-up, isn't it? I think he's almost trying to... Have a look at this. He has gone back to the 50-metre arc, and the man on the mark's 15 metres out. So a 35-metre run-up, if you don't mind, for Tobin Cox. He's kicked 1.5 tonight from 30 metres out. This time, they get around him. Tobin Cox has kicked the goal, and the Adelaide Crows have massive problems.
Here's the build-up again. It was pressure within their front half of Port Adelaide and on the National Pharmacy's optical replay. They do a really good job of maintaining possession. And Tobin Cox finally goes back. He's got 2.5, but none more important than that one there.
Taking 9 marks for the game too. Cox, handball over the top. Farrell sends it back to Attlee. Little kick is a good one. Coming out in the lead there was Davidson. And he goes quick in. Frampton had Otten to deal with. Ryan just gets a little kick out to the advantage. Seymour flicks it out to Boholke. Here goes Sutcliffe coming around and looks up, kicks the ball top of the arc to Boyd Woodcock. What a final series he had last year for North Adelaide. He was fantastic. From 55, Boyd Woodcock launches an absolute ripper.
Here's Woodcock just leaning on that one from outside 50. Gave it everything, and watch the celebration as well. The nice little windmill swirl. He loves it.
6 goal kickers tonight for Port Adelaide. 5 for the Adelaide Crows, and it's all one-way traffic here in the final quarter. Adelaide yet to add to their three-quarter time tally. Porter kicked 3 goals, and Laddams lurking within 10 here at the moment. Dragged off it. Strong tackle, Matt Merritt. Loose ball, Gallucci. He's wrapped up by Laddams going nowhere. Umpire's going to come in here, approaching the 18-minute mark of the final quarter.
Because you'd love this as a ruckman. Geez, he picks the ball up cleanly. Laddams, doesn't he, for such a big man.
It's incredible how he's added it to his game.
Attlee, high kick is way offline. Yeah, look, I think Laddams, he's probably been one of, if not the most improved player in the SANFL competition this year from where he started the season to, you know, playing some AFL footy and look like he's got a really good future.
And when you saw him at Norwood, you thought, oh, there maybe was something there. Forget how young he is. And, of course, ruckmen take longer to develop. And a lot of AFL other clubs sniffing around him. He's gone from strength to strength this year, Peter Laddams. And 5 AFL games, 18th in the competition for contested marks.
High ball, Port Adelaide pressing once more. Frampton can't complete it. Here's Cox, wrapped up by multiple tacklers. And the improvement of Peter Laddams this year basically has cost Paddy Ryder his job at Port Adelaide. 2 years ago, Paddy Ryder was best and fairest in an All-Australian ruckman, and Laddams has gone ahead of him because he has just improved so dramatically here this season. Going to offer so much. Those ruckmen who are midfielders as well as getting their hands on the tap are so crucial in the modern game. Kick here from Lockie Scholl around the body, going back with the flight. Brave stuff there from Corcoran. Matty Wright. Corcoran got it again. Short kick. A hand pass there from Attlee. Didn't do Trengo too many favours. And then the kick was woeful as well. Nice hands there from the security man. Took that one touch.
Yep. We're staying in the play, the security men. Don't worry about that. We've always got eyes on the footy and on the crowd.
Seymour's kick. Oh, cut off there. Good work by Attlee just to get a hand in there. Mays to Frederick. Brought down by Stengel. He's handballed to Appleton. Done okay here. Matthews gets through. He's got some toe. Have a look at him go. Kick is a good one too, to the advantage of Matty Wright. He's got Jones if he needs him, or he can go out here to Jackson Press. A couple of magpies fly, and Press is going to get a free kick.
Now, we're keen to get another look at this one. The ball is coming in with speed, and Adelaide haven't been able to do that too often tonight because they had so many slow build-ups. So going back with the flight, yeah, probably didn't have eyes on the footy, Sam Hayes. And fair enough for the free kick.
1.2 for the year from Jackson Press, a former Woodville West Torrens player. Now the Crows development player from dead in front. Slots it through the middle, so they're back within 19 points.
So
And there's the free kick there. Garner was okay. It wasn't against him. It was against Sam Hayes, who, whilst courageously going back with the flight, really didn't look at the ball. And press just keeps a slight glimmer of hope open for Adelaide.
We saw Sturt come from 38 points down in the last quarter to close to within 14 of Norwood in the elimination final. And the Adelaide Crows back to within 19 points into time on here in this final quarter. And they've got some momentum as well. Kick came there forward from Paholke. Fogarty, strong tackle. Got him a little high as well, but the umpire didn't see it that way. Joel Garner can't believe it, but the umpire's going to come in and ball it up. Let's get another look at Fogarty here.
Garner took the ball off the deck. Now, that's probably justified because the Paholke tackle was so strong. Great contest, though. Maybe could have knocked it out, but good to see a restart.
Adams wins the tap. Lean it. Strong tackle. Paholke brings him down. Tackle count now. Adelaide 55, Port Adelaide 53. It's pretty tight. This qualifying final, it's a very good gauge of premiership hopes here because 40% of this qualifying final winners go on to win the premiership, and another 25% finish second, get to the grand final. So the winner here and qualifying finals have been Port Adelaide's forte. They've won 11 and lost 5, the most qualifying final wins of any team in SANFL history. Up to centre wing. No one can complete the mark. Appleton was good there, thought his way through it, got it to Frampton. Now Willem Drew. Next up, Hayes, the ruckman. Nice kick around the body for Woodcock. Now he can stroll in here, 40 metres out directly in front. The hand goes up. Woodcock has kicked his second goal, and Port Adelaide look home.
So the pressure here, they still push it forward. Woodcock does the rest, finishes off, and they're now starting to find a bit of space. This game's starting to open up, and Port Adelaide seem to have a stranglehold.
4-1 in this term to Port Adelaide. 2 of them off the boot of Woodcock. Laddams takes it out of the air, gives it to Drew. Flicks a handball onto Attlee. Good clearance from Port Adelaide. Hayes, and going back, Merritt couldn't hold onto the mark. He should have got Appleton getting down and trying to work his way forward.
Port Adelaide fans, they are desperate for a premiership case. Their longest premiership drought, their last flag was in 1999. And that goes unheard of when you think of Port Adelaide.
Here we go, Sam Mays again. He's peppered the goals all night, but this one out of bounds. 25 points. The Maggies look like they've booked a ticket to take on the Tigers next week in a semi-final. Crows will front up against Norwood as a kick to Hayes. Didn't quite have enough on it. Attlee flicks out a handball. Wilson's got it. Gallucci over the top to Hutchison. He's got to be quick. Gets his way around Mays. Has a looking board. Smothered. Here's a chance now for Port. They have another crack at it. Farrell drops the ball in there. Good pick up by Merritt. Kick off the ground. Off the deck was Davey. Paholke, middle of the ground to Himmelberg. He's got a runner. Matthews, we know he's got some toe. Kick up is in a good position for Stengel. Getting back was McKenzie. But Stengel has outlasted him, but getting back quickly was Ellsworthy, taking it through from behind.
The defensive cover from the Magpies, not only from their back half, but all of their midfielders working back as well to try and help out their defence. Their work rate away from stoppage has been brilliant, and their spread has been really sharp also.
Here's Laddams. Impressive. A dominant force in the game here, Peter Laddams. I'm happy to slow it down here. The message has gone out. We played 25 and a half minutes. Longest quarter we've seen so far in this game was 28. They're right in the driver's seat with a 4-goal advantage and 24 scoring shots to 15. There's a probably good indication of the dominance of Port Adelaide and the Magpies here against the Adelaide Crows. In front of a crowd of 12,473 is the official number over the two games. A little earlier it was Norwood and Sturt. So 12,473 fans here, and trust you're enjoying our coverage live and free on Channel 7. 4 weekends to look forward to. Next weekend with the 2 semi-finals, I think, is the best weekend of football in the SANFL season, where you've got the top 4 teams remaining. And you've got to look at them all in the one place. Good grab from Tommy Corcoran. Hands over Woodcock. Zigzagging forward. Here's Martin Frederick. Goes for the outside of the right boot. It's going to land in the clutches here of Kane Farrell. Well, they've been threatening to blow the game wide open. right from the get-go here. And Kane Farrell with a chance now to expand the margin up to 30 points.
Hasn't got a goal so far tonight. Kane Farrell from his 21 disposals had two versus the Doggies in the last home and away season. He's going to try and bend this one around the corner. He's got the talent to do it.
Farrell makes some room, brings it around. Expert finish from Kane Farrell. Some icing on a rich cake here for Port Adelaide, who lead by 30 points and are heading for a second semi-final clash against the Tigers.
So no injuries to speak of for Port Adelaide. Get Aidan Johnson back, who just had that one match suspension for striking from the SANFL match review panel. And for the Port supporters out there, the likes of Steve Motlop, Dougal Howard and Zach Butters, they weren't qualified for the SANFL minor round. So this is basically the team you'll get next week when they take on the Yellow and Black Army. The Tigers, won't that be a match that we're looking forward to? So it is these two rival clubs.
Absolutely. It is going to be a huge clash for next week.
Well, Mark Stone spoke on radio today and said that Josh Scott was going to be included in the Glenelg lineup as well, and Liam McBean, so they'll be at full strength. It'll be a great contest between Glenelg and Port Adelaide in the second semi-final. Adelaide against Norwood in the first semi-final. Adelaide has beaten Norwood 2 out of 2 so far this season. So interesting that that is the case. And Glenelg has beaten Port twice this year. 24 points over Glenelg in round 14 when they held Port Adelaide goalless in the first half for the first time at Alberton in 110 years. And a little earlier back in round 8 at Glenelg, it was a 49-point win in favour of Glenelg, who kicked 15 goals at 17. So facing the Magpies won't really bother Mark Stone and the Tigers. We'll see if that form line continues. A lot to look forward to. You see it all live and free here on Channel 7.
And Adelaide will hopefully get Jordan Butts back. He had that concussion down at Norlunga.
Missed him today.
He is a superstar. He's a very good player for the Crows across halfback. Would have made a difference out here today. And there it is.
Well, the Magpies marching on. They're through to the second semi-final here. Their 12th win from 17 qualifying finals, and in the final analysis, it was a 30-point margin. Port Adelaide 12-13, 85 has defeated Adelaide 8-7-55.
Let's head down now to Andrew Hayes.
Thanks very much, sir. I've got the man of the moment, Pete Laddams. Pete's at one of those games where arm wrestle early, you just kept on going, and it finally broke open in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, definitely. I guess we knew if we stuck with it for, you know, the three quarters, it was pretty even at three-quarter time, but then, yeah, floodgates opened at the end there, which we knew was going to happen if we just keep bringing the heat and, you know, the tackle pressure and that sort of stuff. So it was nice to go on to Glenelg next week. It's going to be a good time.
Personally, you're going to have a bit of fun when you check your stats in the rooms a little bit later on, but absolutely cleaned up in all departments. I think it's fair to say you're playing with some serious confidence.
Yeah, definitely. That's something that I've lacked the past couple of years, is that confidence. But, yeah, the coaches and all the players and midfielders are really giving me that confidence this year to take my game to the next level, I guess. So it was good.
Outstanding game, mate. Well done.
Thank you. Cheers.
Yeah, terrific performance from Pete Laddams. 6 clearances, along with his 23 hit-outs and a couple of goals, which was fantastic. And 17 of his 23 possessions were contested. Let's go down to Hazy again.
Thanks, Soda. Joined now by Trent McKenzie. Trent, sensational win. I'm just saying to Pete Laddams, one of those ones where just had to keep on going and eventually just opened up.
Yeah, definitely. It was a tough contest. We knew that right from the start.
took all game just to break him, so we knew that was going to happen, so it was good effort by the boys.
And your game personally, mate, along with Joel Garner, really that rebounding type down back, big role for you tonight as well with Darcy Fogarty?
Yeah, it was. They're a dangerous forward line. They were pretty small in the end, but they've got some good players down there, so we're pretty young ourselves, so it's just trying to take control of the young boys and work well together.
We just spoke to Pete Laddams. His stats are going to be sensational when he checks them. He was on fire, the big man, tonight.
He was. He does it all, the big fella. He crumbs his own ball most of the time, so it's always good when he's playing well. Makes it a lot easier.
Mate, appreciate your time. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Trent McKenzie, good game for him as well. Down back with 11 marks that he took. Terrific performance from Port Adelaide. They end up winning by 5 goals, and they go on to take the Tigers next week in the second semi-final. We've got more coming after the break. We'll hear the Port boys sing the song.
Something big is here.
My time is coming around and I got big plans.
Australia's entirely new streaming channel. The best from US college sports, streaming live and free on 7 Plus. Pac-12, streaming all the time on 7 Plus.
And there they are, the Port Adelaide boys. A great win here in the qualifying final. They'll go through into the second semi-final against the Tigers next week. Let's see the boys sing it loud and proud. Bunch there, and why wouldn't they be? Terrific performance where they were able to pull away from the Crows after what was a really tight tussle. It was all square at quarter time. It was the Crow Port Adelaide by 12 points at half time, 3 points at three quarter time, and obviously that 30 point margin there. Having a look at the numbers, Biggles, Willem Drew, Trengove and Sutcliffe amongst them. Sutcliffe had a big job on Paddy Wilson, did that very, very well. And Sammy Mays with his 3 goals. Woodcock, Laddams with 2, and also Tobin Cox kicked 2-5.
Drew was brilliant around stoppage with his leadership and organisation, and as you mentioned with Sutcliffe, he was really strong around the clearance work and was disciplined as well not to give away any free kicks against Paddy Wilson. Have a look at the uncontested possessions there. Port Adelaide had a heap of them. Clearances went in the favour of Port Adelaide as well, and that was a result of their hit-out work. And well, Peter Laddams was one of the men who was responsible for that. He dominated the hit-outs first to advantage as well, and then his clearance and second effort work around stoppage was right up on the level. And we mentioned throughout the call, this was one of the games for the ages for Peter Laddams. 23 disposals, 17 of those contested, 6 clearances, and then 2 goals. And look at his break and take out of stoppage here. And he was so agile. He was everywhere, wasn't he, Soda?
Half a dozen clearances, really important. And his work below his knees for such a big man, he's very, very clean.
And this is returning from AFL duties, of course, after having a short stint in the top level. And his follow-up work, as we mentioned, he was blocking for people up in the forward line. So not only is he resting up there when he's having a spell out of the centre bounce, but he's actually bringing others into the play. And that'll be pleasing for the coaching staff who are here tonight, particularly Ken Hinckley, who's seen him at the top level and mentioned that after the pre-season, he just knocked down the door on the AFL to get a run up there.
Trent McKenzie did a great job too down in defence, took plenty of marks. And just his contest work against Darcy Fogarty for the night was pretty impressive.
The man they nicknamed the Cannon, he has got a lethal left boot, 27 disposals, 10 contested possessions. Had multiple roles down back tonight. Had the most marks on the park as well. And of those 27 disposals, 24 kicks, only the 3 handballs. So he loves to use that left boot. Was rolling off onto Stengel as well as McAdam. He's got some versatility to his role, and he was vital tonight.
It'd be very, very important for Port Adelaide throughout this whole SANFL Finals campaign. We'll be back shortly with plenty more and to wrap up tonight. A big win for the Magpies there, 30 points.
And look at this one. All Australian selectors.
What? Is that Dusty related, Mick?
Nope, it's Rance. You played only half a game.
I've noticed, Reece, as I caught some vision, some of your assistants seem a bit old. I'm not...
Dad used to make us sing Danny Boy before we were
Oh, Danny Boy, the Pirates are calling.
Special Front Bar Wednesday night with Lee Matthews and Malcolm Blight.
NRL in the second semi-final next week. And, of course, the elimination final today, we saw Norwood get over Sturt by 14 points. So Norwood live to fight another day and they'll take on the Crows, who, well, had their moments, had their chances tonight, no doubt, Biggles, but Port Adelaide kicked away in that last turn with a 5-1.
Yeah, it certainly did. And positive news with no injuries to speak of in both games. I'll probably get Jordan Butts back for the Adelaide Crows, Aiden Johnson back for Port Adelaide from suspension as well. So they'll take on a Tigers outfit and also gets Josh Scott back. So that is going to be exciting footy.
Hey, good player, Jordan Butts. So Seymour and Butts will be in next week, which we look forward to that. Let's head down now to Andrew Hayes.
Thanks, Soto. Joined by Sam May. Sam, sensational results. You've just come out of the team meeting. What did the coach have to say?
Luke's pretty happy with the performance. The lads put in a good one today. It was sort of a tight contest for three quarters there and opened up a little bit in the last, but credit to the Crows. They come out with a pretty strong attitude, pretty tough contest, but we were pretty happy with the result. So
it was tight early. How did you break it open in the fourth quarter? Because they kept on coming, but you really sent it home last.
I think it was just the messaging coming from the coaches and us players. We sort of knew if we were strong in the contest and we kept grinding and grinding, that our best footy had come out at some point. So that's what we did. We were tough in the contest, stuck at it for that first three quarters, and then, yeah, like I said, the last quarter opened up for us and we started to get a few more on the scoreboard.
And for you, especially in those conditions, nice to kick a few goals?
It was quite a nice night. It got a little bit sort of, I guess, easy rain second half. But, yeah, love playing footy here at night. Just getting a good win with the boys. We've got a pretty strong culture here in the Maggies. And we love each other's company and getting wins like that, so.
Speaking of the culture, especially the team song, you guys really did come together. There's a genuine want and desire to win a premiership, because that's when you're talking about, Port Adelaide and the Crows, there's question marks in terms of what you guys are after, but there's a genuine desire to win a flag.
Yeah, every player on our list is striving so hard for it. We just play our role. All sort of 21 of us out there, we know what we have to do. And if we stick to our roles, it doesn't have to be everyone's amazing game, but as long as we're all contributing, we're happy with that. And, like I said, just building a strong culture and wanting to play for each other is so important.
Really appreciate the time. Well done once again.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
There he is, Sammy Mays. Terrific tonight. So next week, already it's going to be a doubleheader. It's on Sunday at 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock are the two starting times. So the Crows taking on Norwood in that semi-final number one and semi-final number two to book a place into the grand final. Glenelg taking on Port Adelaide. It'll be a big match.
It's going to be like the retro 80s again. Glenelg taking on Port Adelaide. Weren't those final series just certainly a memorable one, and chocked full of talent as well, Glenelg, at the moment. They're getting a couple back, and great to hear from their coach this week about how excited they are to try and play in that big one.
Yeah, they are in a very, very good position coming into this final series. Now let's head back down to Andrew Hayes again.
Thanks, Soda. With the skipper, Cam, that was a nice result.
Yeah, it was. Probably would have been nice if we could convert, but I think Tobin Cox will probably do a bit of goal kicking this week. But, it was a good win, and, we're looking forward to playing Glenelg next week.
Well, take us through the Tobin Cox shots, because we spoke to Keith Thomas straight after the game, who couldn't believe you could shank a ball so hard. You've obviously given him some constructive feedback.
Well, I know a few boys said something to him at three-quarter time, so he would have thought about it a fair bit, but last week he kicked him straight, so you can't really tinker with anything too much. But, he's a good kid and he played well.
He played very well. Looking forward to next week. What do you need to improve on?
Probably just that, converting when we get our opportunities. I know we had a fair few inside 50s tonight and didn't quite hit targets. So, we'll probably look at it throughout the week and, work on that. And hopefully that's a pillar to us winning next week.
And you personally, it's been a big season. Obviously came into the AFL side in the later stages of the year, but setting up for a big finish.
Yeah, it is setting up for a big finish. We're all excited here, and all the boys are behind us. So, if we can manage to get past Glenelg next week and have a week off, probably be good for everyone. And but we won't count our chickens before they hatch. But we're really looking forward to it.
Well done, best luck.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Yeah, there he is, Cam Sutcliffe. Did a great job tonight on Paddy Wilson.
Yeah, had some remarkable run back into the defence as well. He worked hard off the footy. He was disciplined around stoppage as well. We saw him go up against Lachie Neal, so we know he can do that run with roll, but actually ended up with more disposals than Paddy Wilson tonight.
Yeah, it's been a big year for Cam Sutcliffe, getting picked up in that mid-season draft after finishing up with his games at Fremantle last year. Of course, been a big day, Biggles. Elimination final. It was the Redlegs that got over the Double Blues by 14 points. It was a cracking match, that game, wasn't it?
Yeah, no doubt. And a little bit of momentum around for the Redlegs at the moment as well. We always
almost thought that elimination final could send a little bit on for the remaining games. And, well, Norwood, they know how to do it. They've been there before, and I reckon they might really take it up to Adelaide next week.
And, of course, Port Adelaide, 30 points over the Crows, as you have just seen. AFL finals start this week coming as well, so we look forward to those on 7. And we'll see you next Sunday for week 2 of our SANFL finals.